The sun is setting in Southern California. A beautiful summer afternoon, now turning into evening. We're at the DoubleTree Hotel in Ontario, California, home of Thompson Boxing in its 23rd year of business. Thank you for joining us on this beautiful Friday night. I'm Beth Durant, alongside the editor-in-chief of Ring Magazine, Doug Fisher, and the youngster of the group, Rich Murata. We'll get into that. He's a young guy, but he has a lot of experience. He started when he was 12 years old. Thank you for joining us tonight. We got six good cards coming your way. Thank you for helping us out. Keep Thompson Boxing going. We're here for you on this Friday night. As always, interact with us on Facebook and on YouTube. Six fights coming your way. And Rich, the main event has a fighter in Jesus Saracho from Mexico, 13-1, against Tarik Zaina from Tijuana, who's undefeated, but yet one of these fighters has a really interesting story, and you're very intrigued.
Yeah, and that's Zaina, who, it's interesting you said he's from Tijuana, which is where he's been for the last couple of years. But let's start out with what intrigues me. He's the first pro boxer from Gibraltar.
Okay.
The Rock of Gibraltar, right? Describes himself as a Moroccan who has gone on to matriculate in England, went to the University of Leeds. He has a bachelor's degree, a master's degree, and then he came.
Why is he boxing?
He's an amazing young man, amazing character. He's actually visited over 50 countries in the time. He speaks four languages, Tarik Zaina, and he came on his own to Tijuana a couple of years back. He had been in England, but when COVID hit, England basically shut down. There was nothing going on in boxing. He needed to go to somewhere to continue to train and maybe to box. He went to Mexico. He went to Tijuana. That's where he's been learning his trade, plying his trade. He's 12-0, and so he's a fantastic story. We love a good story,
absolutely,
a good study in boxing, but it begs the question, can he fight? It's the first time we're going to see him here in the United States, so we will find that out. And the guy who will pose the questions is Jesus Saracho, a tough veteran himself, a similar record, 13-1. So it should be good.
So we're going to find out if the fighter from the Rock of Gibraltar can speak boxeo, as Doug Fisher would like to say. He speaks English, Spanish, and boxeo. And Dougie, we have four fighters on the card tonight that are undefeated. Thompson Boxing, all about building young fighters, but also testing them. It's time for these guys to step up, and they're going to get a good opponent tonight.
Yeah, Thompson Boxing is more than a club show. It's more about just entertaining the fans and attendance and all the hardcore heads watching these streams. It's about developing talent, whatever the fighter's potential is. Sometimes they go on to be world champions. You know, Tim Bradley made it to the International Boxing Hall of Fame.
Started right here.
But for others, it's just about going from four rounds to the six-round level, or from the six-round level to the eight-round level. If you can make it to the eight-round level, you want to make it to the main event. You want to be where Saracho is. You want to get like a minor belt. Going to get you recognized by the sanctioning organizations and hopefully one day the world-class level. And to do that, you got to be tested. And it's a tough road because, you know, you look at Saracho's record, he's got a loss. You look at the fighter, the A-side fighter in the opening bout, Angel Beltran. Yep. Dude can fight. Hell
yes,
of a fighter.
Again.
He's got a loss, though. Yep. So you have to be tested. Win, lose, or draw, it's those hard experiences that take you to the next level.
And you also see Emiliano Moreno, an 18-year-old from Long Beach, making his U.S. debut. He's 5-0 in Mexico. Also, Tatum Beltran makes his Thompson Boxing debut. And Lobito Sanchez will be coming up later on. So six fights coming your way. And you mentioned Tim Bradley, the new Hall of Famer. He started his career here in Ontario with Joel Diaz, who's now training Angel Beltran. Angel Beltran is our first fight of the night. Let's go up to our third man of the group. It's one and only ring announcer, Sonny Franco. Oh, wait, we're going to Jessica? Should I go to Jessica? I don't know. I got so excited to talk to Sonny. You know what? Jessica hasn't been around, but Jessica Rosales, I know you can hear me right now. I know you hate me. Let's hear what Jessica has to say. She's doing the interviews tonight.
All right, guys. Thank you so much. And, of course, thanks to the fans that are joining us today. This is the first Friday of the summer, so we're happy to have you guys joining us here on Thompson Boxing. Now, we do say that these fights are for you, and what we mean by that is we want to know everything that you are thinking, and yes, I mean everything. I say that because the one that really deals with the comments is Beto, Rich, and Doug, but listen, that's beside the point. If you're watching us on YouTube or if you're watching on Facebook, make sure that you guys are interacting in those comment sections. When I say that we are reading those comments, I mean, we are reading those comments and we're reading them out on the air. If you're following along on Twitter, you can use that hashtag Thompson Boxing. Let us know your thoughts. And of course, like I said, we'll be checking them throughout the night. Send your questions in, or of course, just drop in your two cents. Either way, we love to hear it. Now, later on tonight, of course, the guys talked about this a little bit, but let's remind you of the fights that we'll be seeing tonight. We've got four scheduled for six rounds in the super welterweight division. One of our fights later tonight, Jesus Gonzalez and Levy Garcia. Now, we'll be seeing that one coming up a little bit later. That's going to be the fourth fight tonight. Following that, though, in our co-main event, a pretty interesting matchup here. We've got Knuckle Nelson Oliva, Miguel Angel Barajas. Now, if you follow Knuckle Nelson on social media, you've been keeping up to date with his camp, how it's been going. And he says that he is feeling the best he's ever felt. And he's even feeling kind of like an animal. So maybe we'll be seeing that beast out there tonight in that co-main event. They're scheduled for six rounds in the middleweight division. Now, in our main event, this is a really fun one. Es la batalla de México. That's what I'm calling it. Our main event, Jesus Saracho and, of course, Tarik Zaina. Now, the thing about Saracho is that sometimes it takes a loss for you to really kind of step back and rethink your whole game plan. He says that when he was handed his first loss last year, that's exactly what happened, and he had to rethink his perspective on boxing. He has since then won three fights, including beating two undefeated fighters back-to-back, and for the last 5 months, he says that he has had the best training camp of his life. Now, Tarik Zaina, as Rich mentioned, has a very interesting story, 12-0, undefeated. But for him, this is his first time fighting in the States. He knows a lot of people are going to be watching, and he's hoping to make a statement. For him, the game plan is to hurt his opponent early and to end the night early as well. So that is the main event, scheduled for 10 rounds. An exciting night of boxing tonight, and of course, our first fight is on deck. Let's go ahead and check it out before they enter in the ring.
A very good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. We're coming to you from the Doubletree Hotel here in the beautiful city of Ontario, California, where tonight, Thompson Boxing Promotions is proud to present a night of championship boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, these fighters have trained hard to be here. They've paid to be here, and you pay to see them lay it all on the line right here inside the ring. And with that being said, there's only one question left to ask, and that is, Ontario, are you ready? Let's get the party started. Please welcome on the red corner from Accra, Ghana. Here is Abraham ECG Afoul.
Our first bout of the night, ready to walk. Abraham Afoul from Accra, Ghana, 12-4-1. Oh, he's enjoying the dance. There you go.
He's kind of a mystery man.
Kind of.
But I've seen him score a couple of knockouts over there in Ghana with one punch. I mean, he's got quite obviously 12 wins and 12 KOs as his record. The competition's a little different over here.
Yeah. The record indicates he's got heavy hands, but if you look at Box Rec, you also notice he's never defeated a fighter with a winning record.
I'll tell you this, though. That's how you open up a Friday night show on Thompson.
Yeah, I like the vibe. I like the energy.
Strutting to the ring with confidence.
And going the wrong way, too.
Well, yeah.
He's going to walk right by us. This way, bro. Come on. Right over here. You got this side. Come on, commission. What are we doing? There he goes.
Does he have a corner man tonight?
So he picked up a couple of the guys from Mexico for this fight.
Because there's nobody over there.
Yeah. And now, please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring out of the blue corner from Mexicali, Mexico. Here is Angel A.B. Beltran.
Angel A.B. Beltran, 16-1, a good young fighter from Mexicali. Does his camp with Joel Diaz in Coachella, and there you see Coach to his side. Normally, he's going across the border, back and forth, the hour and a half, hour 45. For this one, stayed 2 months in the camp house with Joel. He was Chakram Gyasa, who just had a recent victory, his main sparring partner. Also, I forget how to say his first name, Doug, Butayev.
Rodzab Butayev.
So that was
welterweight contender.
So Joel said, stay here.
And I think that's good work. That's hard work.
I have a feeling that sparring session camp is going to be tougher than what we got tonight.
Yeah, well, he scored he looked like a quality fighter, certainly. The last time we saw him, he scored a mild upset over Luis Lopez that night. Lopez coming in as the A side with all the fans. And he
looked really good, yeah. He looked like a complete fighter in there. It surprised me as well as Luis Lopez with that first round knockdown.
It was a terrific knockdown, actually. A fantastic left hook.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, good evening and welcome. We're coming to you from the DoubleTree Hotel here in the beautiful city of Ontario, California, where tonight, Thompson Boxing Promotions is proud to present a championship night of boxing. We begin tonight's event with the first bout of the evening, scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing in the welterweight division. Sponsored by Makita Tools, Bellegarde, Omega Products International, and Hustler Casino Los Angeles. Your three judges scoring this bout, should it go the distance, are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Gerard White. Fight fans, here we go. Introducing first, fighting under the red corner. He steps in the ring tonight with a black trunks with white. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 146.6 already pounds. As a professional, his record stands 12 victories against 4 defeats with 1 bout even. Ladies and gentlemen, join us tonight from Accra, Ghana, here is Abraham ECG Abu. And introducing his opponent, fighting across the ring out of the blue corner. He stepped in the ring tonight wearing the black trunks. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 144.5 solid pounds. As a professional, he has 17 fights to his credit, including 16 victories against 1 defeat, 9 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Mexicali, Mexico, introducing Angel A.B. Beltran. Once again, the referee in charge, Gerard White, give the final instructions.
And here, Abraham, you want to introduce the dressing room. Trunks are good here, a little hot here, I'll let you work right here. Touch him up, let's go to work.
Gerard White, the third man in the ring, as we look at the tail of the tape.
Yeah, and there's not much separating these welterweights, physically speaking. Beltran has a slight height advantage, and Aful has a slight reach advantage.
All right, Lou Duva, who's checking in on YouTube. What time will it be the main event? I would say right now it's 8:15 Pacific. We're looking around 10 o'clock, I would say. Thompson Boxing has 6 fights coming your way, and I'm looking at all the comments on YouTube right now. So everybody, we checking out here. And right away, Angel Beltran, aggressive, with a record of 16-1, 9 KOs. Digging into the punches.
I'm surprised to see Aful fired that left hook this early in the fight.
And his mouthpiece is out.
Well, he's a puncher. He wants to make he'd like to make a statement, a positive statement here tonight, fighting in the United States. Now, he's fighting. I've seen some of his fights over in Ghana, and really he's fought sometimes in these ballrooms where there's like 10 or 15 people.
Yeah, auditoriums and ballrooms. There's
nobody there. I mean,
right.
There's the jab to the stomach and the head.
Yeah.
And from the YouTube footage I watched, he he had a busy jab.
Yeah, good
worked
job.
The jab before, you know, swinging with the power shots.
He's a little bit unorthodox, a rangy fighter, and as we mentioned, heavy hands.
Benito Gonzalez watching us in Chicago. Hello to you, Toby Bartlett. So yes, we do read all the comments, at least on the YouTube page. I'm watching it. Our first bout of the night, scheduled for 8. Coming up next will be Emiliano Moreno making his U.S. debut. He's 18 years old. And Tatum Beltran from Huntington Beach, Jesse Gonzalez, Nelson Oliva, and then our main event later on tonight.
I'm just a little skeptical on the age. I know on the tail of the tape we saw it at 26. That, but then again, you know, Sonny Liston always looked like he was 20 years older than he listed his age.
Good jabs from Angel Beltran, snapping the jabs. Stephen Bass, I can't believe this guy came over with nobody work his corner. We have somebody who brought him over like a manager, but, you know, that. Oh, and Beltran digging to the body. And in trouble is a fighter from Ghana. Beltran staying composed, digging to the body.
Remember, Beltran scored that first round knockdown of Luis Lopez when he took control of the fight right there. So he comes out and he means business right from the opening bell.
Yeah, but he's patient. He doesn't rush himself. He waits for the right time. And he was wise to start tapping the body of Afful from the opening bell. Because it's, you know, Afful can move around a lot. So, you know, he slowed him down. And he's, I think he's working on not just weakening Afful, but also bringing that guard down, bringing those arms down so he can get a clean headshot like that.
Man, saw 10 seconds to go in the opening round. Angel Beltran looking good here in Thompson Boxing. Ontario, California, Friday night action. Starting out hot with Beltran.
Well, that last minute was a nightmare for Afful.
Paul, that, can we bring it down? No, the crowd mic, can we bring that down?
Afful looks to me like in the corner, he doesn't look good. He looked to me like he'd be shaking his head. No, I don't know if he wants any more of this. This fight may get stopped.
He's shaking his head to the referee. It's over.
It's over. A lot of damage for Angel Beltran in a first round stoppage. Para el muchacho de Mexicali, azul a toda gente que lo está mirando en Mexicali.
They were asking him in the corner if he wanted to go on. He was signaling no. He was shaking his head.
The body shots took it out of him.
He did, yeah. Angel Beltran he's very impressive now. This is, the fight with Luis Lopez, as we mentioned, a mild upset. He certainly wasn't the A-side that night. And he even when Lopez fought his way back into the fight, as you mentioned, he was patient, Doug, and he fights a very mature fight. And certainly picked up as that minute by minute in that first round here tonight.
You know what I'm saying, what he's getting from the Diaz camps is he's more confident and he's getting physically stronger. He's punching with more authority.
We'll come back with more from Thompson Boxing in Ontario.
If you're at this table, you know that it's more than a game of luck. You're not here for the small talk. You're here for the action. If you're at this table, you're a hustler. Hustler Casino.
Experience the world's largest compatible cordless system. Makita's LXT batteries take you from power tools to outdoor power equipment. The blower delivers power comparable to a 24cc gas model. From the job site to your home, reach speeds of 116 miles per hour. Use Makita's cordless products anytime, anywhere. One system, endless possibilities. Now get two extra free batteries.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes. At the end of round number one, at the advice of the opponent's corner, declaring your winner by KO from Mexicali, Mexico, Angel A.P. Beltran.
Angel Beltran is now 17-1. Abraham, a fool falls for the fifth time in his career. A lot of Beltran. I like it, Rich. Come in, dominate, end it quick.
Right, and from a fool standpoint, judging from what we saw of him in a limited amount of tape, he never faced a body attack like that. And that was a whole new experience and a nightmarish one for him against Beltran, who looks to me like he's building himself quite a future.
Yeah, it's a 17-1, 10 knockouts. That's a good record. We've seen him in against better opposition than Afuul in his previous bout against Luis Lopez. To me, he's on his way to being a solid fringe contender. And he may have potential to actually be a legitimate contender.
Yeah, coming out of Mexicali, his only loss early in his career, he's made some adjustments, and you see it. We said it, the work that he gets with Joel Diaz, Antonio Diaz at training camp, and sparring all those Uzbek fighters where, okay, one day you might have it easy. The next day, geez, now this guy? Now this guy?
I don't think it's ever easy.
No, yeah, at all. And Angel Beltran, good personality too from Mexicali. Saludos a todos los cachanillas, El Coyote was singing for that. Coming up next, Emiliano Moreno, Tayden Beltran, Lobito Gonzalez, Nelson Oliva, Jesus Saracho. Five more fights coming your way. And I see all the comments on the YouTube. And just to let you know, Steve Kim, well, he got rid of us for Mario Lopez. Let's go to Sonny Franco.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get the action going once again. Please welcome out of the red corner as he makes his way to the ring from Las Vegas, Nevada. Here is Christian Secret Weapon Dominguez.
Christian Dominguez, now living in Las Vegas. Grew up in Santana. That's where he was cutting his teeth as an amateur. Now in Vegas. Y saludos a toda la gente que nos está mirando del DF, de Ciudad México. Cristian Dominguez has a big following here on the YouTube page. And hello, everybody cheering on Cristian Dominguez. Another one. Another one bites the dust for Cristian Dominguez. The secret weapon. What a nickname right there.
I like it.
I tell you what, you walk out to this, you got to score a knockout.
All right, so Dominguez is is Cuban. Yeah, but I know that, but there's a lot of people watching in Mexico City that are cheering him on. I'm reading all the comments, man. I know what's going on here.
Tough fighter, though, this. Dominguez. Very competitive. He also fought.
And now, please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring out of the blue corner. From Long Beach, California, here is Emiliano El Revolucion Moreno.
Emiliano Moreno, 5-0, 4 KOs, making his U.S. debut. Long Beach, California roots. Training in Seattle.
I'm digging this outfit.
Yeah, I was going to mention the poncho. That is
beautiful.
Yeah. Virgen de Guadalupe, Serape. Walking in the United States for the first time. Already has the mouthpiece in. he's locked in.
There were a lot of people walking out in the lobby and the hallway here with Team Emiliano t-shirts on.
Look to the left of us, guys. Oh, everybody's standing up for this young man.
Yeah, the blue and fluorescent orange. Very nice. You said that he trains in Seattle?
Yes, so his father moved to Seattle along with Benavidez Sr.
Right.
So this kid, I saw him, he used to go to The Rock when Benavidez goes farther. He was 11, 12 years old. Now he's 18 as a professional here.
So he's training in the Benavidez camp.
Not there, but they know the Benavidez.
Oh, okay, I see.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thompson Boxing Promotions continues on with the next bout of the evening. Scheduled for 8 rounds of action in the junior welterweight division. Being sponsored by Westlake Royal Stone Solutions, Thompson Building Materials, Omega Products International, and Infinity Bank. Your three judges scoring the bout should it go the distance are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Thomas Taylor. Fight fans, here we go. Introducing first, fighting under the red corner. He steps in the ring tonight with a white trunks with black. When he stepped onto the scale, he went officially at 141.2 already pounds. As a professional, his record stands 11 victories against 5 defeats. 6 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, joining us tonight from Sin City, Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Christian, the secret weapon, Dominguez. And introducing his opponent, fighting across the ring out of the blue corner. He stepped in the ring tonight wearing the gold trunks. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 141.9 already pounds. As a professional, he enters the ring tonight undefeated. 5 wins with 0 losses. 4 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, he's the fighting pride of Long Beach, California. Put your hands together and welcome Emiliano El Revolucion Moreno. Once again, your referee, Thomas Taylor, to give the final instructions.
Hey, Carlos de Santiago, we get it, bro. We see all the Cuban flags. We get it, man. We see them. Oh, now he puts Mexican flags.
Belt lines on both sides are good. Got my instructions in the back. Protect yourselves at all times. Listen to my commands. Touch them up. Back to corner.
Tom Taylor, the third man in the ring. Solid referee. Let's look at the tail of the tape.
Yeah, Moreno, the much younger man at 18, 14 years younger, is by far the taller of the two, and he has 2 inches in wingspan.
5-0, 4 KOs, but very untested because he's fighting in Mexico. And, you know, you're very soft. As Steve Kim would say, they give you the Similac down there. And he gets a fighter with 16 professional fights, and Christian Dominguez could be. That should tell you something of what they think about Moreno in his corner.
Well, his manager, Ray Fry, is gung-ho over him. I can tell you that. And this is his first fight in the USA, so he might have a little case of the jitters.
Machina Boxing is where they've been doing their fights down in Mexico, bringing along this young man. So imagine he lives in Seattle now along with his father. They went up there with Benavidez, moved up there. Then they went on their own. Got their own gym going, making their own moves. 6 foot. Talked to him briefly in the back. Very solid approach. Did not sound like he's 18. I have an 18-year-old. And this kid sounded like he was 24, 25.
But he looks like he's 18. Yeah. That's the body of a young man who's still growing. And if he grows into that frame, you know, by the time he's 21 or 22, he could be a middleweight.
Wow. And he gets...
Left hook.
Whoa, left hook. Quick wobbly is Dominguez.
Man.
We said he was untested in Moreno. Well, he's showing us, Beto, shut up. Let me show you what I can do.
That was a stunner. One punch knockdown. A real solid
overhand
shot.
Right wobbling Dominguez, who's in trouble.
Emiliano has a real chance
yes,
here.
Yes, he does. Oh, that hook dropped him again.
Yep, that's a technical knockdown. Only the ropes kept Dominguez up.
Dominguez in a world of trouble, and the 18-year-old Moreno making his U.S. debut, a good one here.
And there's still a long way to go in this first round.
And I don't think we're going to get out of this first round. Oh, big shots thrown by the 18-year-old. Looking to unload and end it. Dominguez trying to fight back.
Moreno shouldn't try to force it. That first punch that dropped Dominguez, he just dropped it. He wasn't forcing it at all.
It was smooth.
Yeah, it was nice, smooth, compact left hook on the inside. Now it looks like he's loading up.
Yeah, it's hard when you're 18 years old,
exactly,
though, with a handful of fights, you score a couple of knockdowns like that.
Yeah, but he needs to take a deep breath, use his jab, maybe tap the body.
I liked how he backed off there after scoring a couple of punches, got this distance once again.
This time going to the body is Moreno. Dominguez still winging punches. Now he's eating punches. The crowd oohing and on with everything that Moreno throws. Uppercut hook. He's wobbling against the ropes. 10 seconds to go in the first round. Heck of a first round for Moreno. And Dominguez survives the first, and Tom Taylor's taking a long look. And I don't know if Taylor's going to let this one continue.
Yeah, and you know, another referee would have stopped the fight.
Yeah.
But I applaud Taylor for not stopping it because Dominguez was still winging back.
Yeah,
let's see this first knockdown. It happened so fast. Boom. Oh, that was the second knockdown.
Second one.
Yes. But it was another short hook. He's dangerous from a distance.
Whoa.
He's dangerous in close. He's dangerous from a distance with the straight right.
Well,
there you see him landing that
straight
right. I like
how he fights tall.
Wow.
Man,
I want to see the first knockdown, though, because that was just out of nowhere.
So quick.
Yes.
Thomas Taylor just left the corner.
And I don't know, Tom's an excellent referee. If Dominguez gets tagged again hard, I don't know if he's going to let it go.
Yeah, I hope he steps in because Dominguez's head was violently snapped back a number of times
in that opening round. He'll be on a short leash, you can be sure.
And right away, Moreno comes out strong, picking up where he left off in the first.
Again, Moreno fighting tall again. Look at him keep that distance. He lands big power punches from long range.
Dominguez gets one in and then eats another hook. Nose is busted. Dominguez in white.
Dominguez must be in tremendous shape just to have lasted this long.
He's got 16 fights under his belt, Dominguez. He's a gamer, he battles. He's got Guerrero tattooed on his body, and he just got tagged on the Guerrero tattoo.
Well, he's a super competitive guy, as we mentioned in our pre-fight comments. And, you know, he's a guy who went the distance. He's another one who fought Luis Lopez, went the distance, lost a very close decision to Lopez. So he's not accustomed to being blown out of there.
I like that, the 18-year-old being patient here in the second.
I'd like to see him soften Dominguez up with just the jab. Jab to the chest, jab to the head, jab to the stomach.
Just jab him up?
Yeah, jab him, because jabs will get a fighter dizzy. You've already hurt him in the opening round. You already, you know, busted the nose. So, you know, Dominguez, it's difficult getting oxygen in there. Just relax, kind of work on your craft, back him up. Once he's against the ropes, unleash to the body.
And Dominguez looks like he's got his legs back.
Yeah, and he's punching with authority.
Yeah, he's all body shots from Dominguez. Okay, he's game. Overhand right from Dominguez.
Dominguez is showing not just grit.
A hook from Dominguez.
And courage, he's showing maturity.
Overhand right from Dominguez.
Yeah.
And a big right from Moreno counters. Answers. Dominguez on the ropes. They're both winging. Dominguez says, come on. He's asking for it. Oh, we got a heck of a battle here. Dominguez is battling. Moreno in the corner. Chucking a hook.
Dominguez's best punch is his overhand right. He should keep throwing that. But he's got to be careful to protect that side of his body because of the hook from Moreno.
This is good because he's asking some real questions of Moreno here.
It looked like it was going to be a blowout in the first, but Dominguez coming back strong in the second. Game. Battle.
And I think Dominguez has discovered that if he gets in real close to the kid and kind of smothers him,
yep,
it's a little more safe than being middle distance like that.
Overhand right from Dominguez, who's closing the round well. This is a fun fight. 10 seconds to go in the second. Tide is turning.
Dominguez may have won this round.
Yes, that was fun. Bigger shots for man for Dominguez. I thought it was gonna get stopped early, no? Respect to Dominguez to come out here and get out here. That's Jessica, Wrestler Babe, our third ring girl tonight. Let's look at some highlights from the Hustler Casino.
Oh, that overhand right. That was the ticket for Dominguez to work his way back into this fight, along with the body shot. Now, he had to weather the storm early in the round, but there's that overhand right.
Yeah.
Timed it perfectly from mid-range.
Mid-range to long range is where Emiliano wants to be, but once Dominguez got him pinioned up against the ropes, things changed.
And you'll notice Dominguez was also sneaking body shots to Moreno. Body shots was the key weapon for Dominguez when Moreno's back was against the ropes.
And this is why you give Tom Taylor, veteran referee, credit. Knowing that Dominguez has 16 pro fights will give him a little bit longer.
Yeah.
And you see Dominguez answering to the second.
He could have stopped that fight after the first round.
And nobody would have argued.
And this is great experience for the 18-year-old Emiliano Moreno. And Rich, if you're Moreno, you don't want to get in that firefight with the desperate fighter, correct?
That's correct, and I think he's taking the right tack here at the start of round three. Look at, he's right in the middle of the ring where he wants to be, keeping the fight at long range, utilizing his jab, and wants to pick him apart from long range here.
I still think Moreno's loading up just a little bit too much. He's in there with a mature, grizzled fighter, guy who's proven that he's going to battle back from adversity. He's going to shake loose the cobwebs. He takes a good shot.
But that's what an 18-year-old does, too,
yeah,
right?
That's, no, 18, they're going to go for the gusto. But then it's up to the corner to remind them, hey, this isn't a four-round fight. This is a scheduled eight-rounder. You've got to pace yourself.
Another big thing is it's an eight-rounder for a kid who's only 5-0. Usually it's somebody 5-0 going four rounds.
Oh, absolutely.
Rounds.
Yeah, no more than six rounds. So he has to be aware of that. And I think it's smart just to work behind the stick, work from a safe distance, look for his shots, and sure, go for the gusto when you got this guy hurt, but even then, be careful, because as I said, Dominguez has proven the ability to battle back from adversity.
And Dominguez is gonna bite on that mouthpiece and give right back up. Went down twice in the first.
Moreno doesn't use his jab as a probing jab or a range finder. He uses it to hurt his opponent. He throws it out there with a lot of power and a lot of meaning.
Our second bout of the night, Thompson Boxing. I see all the comments on YouTube. Yeah, good one. Make sure you share the link. Tweet it out like our man Julius Julianes. Saludos, Julius. Benito Gonzalez, you're talking about Berlanga, man. We'll get into that later on tonight. We got a good scrap right here. We'll get into the conversations with Doug and Rich Murata. Well, now you have a good 18-year-old and Emiliano Moreno being tested here. And Dominguez sees those jabs coming to move around.
It's just going to be interesting to see how mentally Moreno handles the fact that this guy is still there and still fighting back.
Good. What happens when you have a guy who just doesn't do anything? What's that do for you? And then when you have to get tested, nothing happens. Third round in the books. All right, Karma Suge. You keep asking me how much did I lose on the Ryan fight against Tank? Who said I lost? As Joel Diaz is coming in. He's gonna be in the corner of Tarik Zaina. Yeah, man, I didn't lose on that fight. And there you see Emiliano Moreno with his father in his corner.
He's pretty calm over there. I like the way that he reacted in that third round.
Yeah, he looked very settled.
And over the mouthpiece in?
Yeah, the second part of the round, he was working behind that stick. And you're right, it's a shotgun jab. Complete with sound effects.
Yeah, he yells every time he throws it.
Doesn't he?
A la Monica Seles at Wimbledon? Old reference.
Yeah, that is. You're showing your age.
I'm getting there. Coming up next, Tatum Beltran, Gerardo Fuentes. What up, Shoeshine Boxing? If you just joining us right now, Emiliano Moreno dropped Christian Dominguez twice in the first round. And in the second, Dominguez answered back, getting back into this fight. Third round was a little bit back and forth. Good hooks landed by Moreno.
I like that short lead left hook that Moreno has. It's real sneaky and there's a lot of power, even when it looks like he's not getting a lot of leverage on it.
18 years old, Emiliano Moreno, not much of an amateur. And the learning experience when you leave Mexico to fight in the United States.
We've got a lot of those guys on the card tonight.
Yes, we do.
First fights in the USA.
And you know what? Also, credit to Moreno's team because they could have found somebody who's, you know, 6-8. That's not going to give you that professional resistance. And Dominguez is here making it tough.
Dominguez is a solid fighter. And he's not just a solid fighter, he's a competitor.
And he looks like he's trying to figure something out. He's tried a couple of new tacks here in the third round.
All right, Michael Mendiola. Moreno needs a lot of work. His fundamentals are flawed. He's 18.
Yeah, he's not one of these guys who had 200 amateur fights.
What up to Stu Mack in the hospital watching us on his tablet. What up, Stu?
Get well soon.
Winston-Salem, North Carolina, checking in. Steve Mata.
Moreno is showing that he can control the distance. He's got some decent lateral movement.
All right, Dougie, educate me here. What's a Gene Fulmore hammer jab? That comes from Deciding Paper 632. Educate us here, Editor-in-Chief.
Well, Rich would know.
Well, that's that jab that comes down.
Like a tomahawk.
It starts up high and comes.
Big right hand from Moreno.
Yeah, that was a two-piece. I think it was a right followed by a short hook.
Another hook.
Tell you what.
Moreno keeps coming.
Dominguez is a tough cat, man. Kudos to him. And I'm surprised at the authority that Moreno has on his punches as an 18-year-old.
Well, because he's dictating the style of the fight. He's dictating the geometry of the fight. He's controlling the distance in there, fighting the correct fight.
That was a good two-piece on the inside, landed by Dominguez after Dominguez had gone to the body. And Moreno's making him pay for it.
Shout out to the Green Room in Newark, New Jersey. Our main event, Jesus Saracho, is a Tierra de las Momias, Guanajuato, Mexico. He's our main event coming up later on tonight.
Saracho, 3 pounds overweight yesterday. Wow. Was very disappointed in that.
Look at the replays from that fourth round.
Moreno working well off the jab, landing the right hand off the jab. Good 1-2 combinations. Dominguez showing that amazing chin, taking those punches, those 1-2 combinations, flush.
He walked back to his corner, shaking his head a little bit, though.
He's taking some damage. Dominguez is taking a lot of physical damage.
And we're going to stay in the corner here.
I'm looking at Dominguez's corner, though, which is right next to us. Trainer's talking to him, pulling on his trunks so he can take some deep breaths.
Yep. All right, so here we go. Get ready for the fifth round. Boxing MMA Esquire, saludos! If you need an immigration lawyer, that's our man right there in Calexico. Also, commissioner here. works for the California Commission.
Moreno, you may have seen it, looked over at his cheering section just before the round started. He's waving.
He wanted some moral support.
They got his back.
Get loud. Get loud. It gets loud at the Doubletree. The Green Room Cigar Lounge wants to shut up. Nah, man. Send me a Arturo Fuente, please, or a Cohiba. It's a good round. Good fight. Did not expect that it'd be this long.
Oh, it looked like it was over in the opening round.
Just want to make a quick note. I talked to Thomas Taylor, the referee, before the fights tonight, and congratulated him on getting that assignment, that big, humongous fight. Of course, Gervonta Tank Davis and Ryan Garcia did a good job in there that night and was the one who counted out Ryan at the end of the fight. And that was a big, big break for Thomas to get a big fight like that.
Yeah, Taylor used to be a under-the-radar California favorite, and he's well-known now. I would say he's international now.
Good for him to get an opportunity in Vegas, and good for Vegas to get some new blood and box in there.
Yeah, I think Vegas needs new blood.
James Smith, just to let you know, your boy Tatum Beltran will be fighting next, so stick with us. They're talking about Joshua Franco coming in 6 pounds over in Japan. Robert Garcia said he had a tough camp for Franco. They were talking about maybe turning it off this week, but he will be fighting. Stripped of the WBA title. Only Ioka can win it.
Dominguez is hanging out.
Yep.
He's sticking in there, but his offense has dropped noticeably.
Now for Moreno, heading to uncharted territory. 5-0, 4 KOs.
He did have one other fight that was scheduled for 8 rounds, but he ended that one in the third.
Yeah.
So.
And that's all Moreno's crowd making noise. All right, Crayfish and everybody else, enough with the trolling comments, man. We have a good chat going on here. It's not a normal boxing, everybody talking trash to each other. Interact with each other in a good way, man. Just leave the trolling alone, man. That gets old quick.
Leave the trolling for Twitter.
Yeah. Doug's email.
Yes, thank you.
Good round. Good action, back and forth. Respect to Christian Dominguez, Emiliano Moreno.
Dominguez tried to turn it into a firefight there at the end of the round and had some success, but then he paid for it.
Yeah, he gets the worst of those exchanges.
Up next, there it is, Tatum Beltran from Huntington Beach makes his Thompson Boxing debut against Gerardo Fuentes. And then after that will be Lobito Gonzalez, Nelson Oliva, and then our main event, Saracho. Sleeper. Well, just ignore these people. I don't know who's talking trash, but just ignore them all. Let's talk about the fights here. Let's have some fun. You have Rich Murata and Doug Fisher. Interact with them instead. If you guys want to troll, go to Mario Lopez's page. 3 knockdown rule with Steve Kim. Go there. What up, Webb? All right, 6th round of action. Dominguez will not go away. He's in the white trunks after going down the first two, twice in the first round.
Dominguez turned the fight into a barn burner in the second round, but he may have used himself up a lot with that offensive assault that he himself launched.
Yeah, if he could have kept that up, it would have been very interesting to see what kind of condition Moreno would be in here in round 6. But I think that second round, which by the way, I did score for him. That was the only round where he was able to really put sustained hands on Moreno.
18-year-old Emiliano El Revolucion Moreno.
a taller fighter against Christian the Secret Weapon Dominguez.
Dominguez has some moments.
Yes, he does.
And especially when he can get Moreno to back up against the ropes.
16 professional fights. B-side for most of them. He knows what's going on. Oh, crayfish, man. You're better than that. Daniel Ochoa. Familia Ochoa in Blythe, California. Shout out to you.
I did notice that one of the folks tweeting tonight on did mention a thank you to Ken Thompson for streaming these fights.
Yes.
Fights free of charge for people to see. Yeah. The entire cards, main events included.
Twitter, Thompson Boxing, the YouTube, and the Facebook page, Free Boxing For You.
I did notice when I walked in that Ken Thompson, of course, who passed away earlier this year, was not there greeting the fans.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was
legendary Ken Thompson. 23rd year of Thompson Boxing. You've seen the trucks all over Southern California. Those Thompson Building Materials, same organization. Champions made here recently. Timothy Bradley was in International Boxing Hall of Fame. Friday night, action for you. Hardcore fans, we appreciate you joining the lifeline of boxing.
Dominguez a little desperate, switched to left-handed there for about 30 seconds.
Yeah, and as Roger also says, you know, Mr. Thompson kept boxing going here in Southern California during the pandemic because we would do those shows at Omega Products International in their own bubble when club shows are, you're not making much money, if any, let alone to put on a show during the pandemic. So, of course, did a great job to keep his fighters employed,
yes, exactly.
His employees going, and the broadcasters.
We appreciate it.
Yep. What up, Dave Days? Coming up next, Tayden Beltran, and after that, Lobito Gonzalez, Nelson Oliva, Jesus Saracho, Jacob Alvarez, Richard Brewer. Don't know when he's fighting, but I'm looking at him. He's right here with his dad. Crappy Grandpa, you got to be better than that. Come on now. Friday, July 21st, the next show here at the Doubletree in Ontario. Joining us. Michael Mendiola. He's 18. They know they need to work on something. There's a reason.
Folks are criticizing the
yes.
young man. I'm impressed. Yeah, obviously, he lacks polish.
He should.
There are things he needs to work on.
He should.
Yeah, he's still a boy. But I'm seeing power. I'm seeing the basics there. He does have a decent foundation.
Yeah.
He has a foundation that can be built upon.
Most 18-year-olds are still amateurs.
I'm seeing
that's
a lot of good things in there. I love his jab.
Yes.
I love the way he listens in his corner, too.
Yes. Ricardo El Niño Sandoval, saludos. Just recently had a victory on the Golden Boy Show at the Toyota Arena.
Yeah, legitimate flyweight contender. Should be getting a title shot very soon.
Two knockdowns from Emiliano Moreno in the first round.
And I've got him winning every round except for round two. But I you know, he's pacing himself. And, you know, we're seeing some lateral movement for him. I think he's really good at controlling the distance. He's doing a good job of keeping Dominguez at the end of his punches.
And valuable rounds, valuable experience.
Yeah.
He's very athletic in there.
How many rounds did he have coming into this fight? He only had 5 pro fights, 4 knockouts.
Not many.
Not many at all.
16 rounds.
16 rounds coming into this fight for Emiliano Moreno. None of them were this hard. I like it. You put them up top, you test them, and you see what you're about.
And he's in there with not an opponent. He's in there with a
tough dude.
Yeah, a guy who wants to win.
Winston Salem, North Carolina. Saludos, Sotelo. The Ozarker checks in. Of course, Doug, your people.
All right. 417. Oh, Dominguez landed a nice right hand.
Tito Trinidad. Yes, the fight is better if you meet the commentary. Absolutely.
Once again, that success by Dominguez was accomplished, Doug and Beto, when he was able to pinion Moreno against the ropes.
Yes. But Moreno's done a good job to keep his back off those ropes.
He does punch down with that jab a lot of times. You can see.
And you'll be able to learn as you move forward. That's all it's about right now. Bakersfield, California, Ramon Estrada, saludos. 336, Steven Mata.
If you remember, Chris Areola's right hand, his power shots used to come from way above.
It looked like he was chucking a shot put.
Here, right?
Oh, no, he kept that weird right hand all the way up the heavyweight ladder.
No, Areola fought here.
Oh, yes, he did. He fought in this room. Yep.
10 seconds to go in the seventh round. Dominguez is a tough dude. Respect to him.
There can't be five people in this room who thought this fight was going to go the distance after witnessing the first round.
None. Welcome to the Jungle Jammin'. Nelson Oliva will be our co-feature coming up later on tonight. That's the corner of Dominguez from Santana originally, now living in Las Vegas. Minor Watto in Tijuana. Respect to two fighters. Dominguez went down twice in the first round. We thought the fight was close to being stopped, and he's battled back, tough as nails. A very, very tough opponent. And for the first time in his career, Emiliano Moreno goes to the eighth round. Jimmy Rosner watching us in Toronto. What's up, man? I'll be up there for a United Promotions card later on this summer. Beautiful in the six. Sixteen pro rounds coming into this one, huh, Rich? And he gets eight hard ones tonight. Or maybe seven hard. The first one was easier. Beto Duran, Rich Murata, and Doug Fisher, the editor-in-chief of Ring Magazine, with you here.
If Dominguez was holding anything in reserve, now's the time to unleash it.
Just a tough dude. Carlos Villanueva in Yakima, Washington. What's up? Webb has Moreno up. What about you, Doug?
I have Moreno up 69-63. I have him winning every round except for round two. And of course, the opening round was 10-7 in his favor.
Valentin Romero, fantastic boxing photographer watching in Long Beach. Why aren't you here, Valen? This is a guy you shot since he was an amateur. Where are you at?
You know, I really don't like that downward trajectory of the jab. When he throws a straight jab, Emiliano, it's a good, powerful jab. But when he brings it from down, from up top and brings it down, I think it loses power.
He's also 6 foot, Rich. That has something to do with it? And he's fighting a guy who's 5'7"?
It's possible, yeah. It's just the... I have the feeling that that's just a habit he's got.
Okay.
Into, yeah.
Yeah, Rich, everybody on the chat is right there with you on that downward jab. Nobody likes it.
They're down on the down jab.
There it is.
There's definitely more snap when he throws it straight.
Right. Or even if he brings it up from down below, it'll get more power.
Yeah.
AZ Rock, I see that, man. No quema, we got it already. As the fight winds down, good action. Emiliano Moreno, Cristian Dominguez, they put on a heck of a scrap. 8 good rounds between the two. Dominguez went down twice in the first, and it'll go to the judges' scorecards, respect between the two fighters. We'll come back with a decision in Thompson Boxing on a Friday night.
Live from the Hustler Casino in Gardena, California. Watch the most well-known local and international poker players take the stage and go all in. From low stakes to high stakes, the action will be wild. Tune in to Hustler Casino Live, streaming 5 days a week on YouTube.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to make a round of applause for both of these warriors. 8 fantastic rounds at the books. And now to the judges' scorecards we go for the official decision. Both judges, Dr. Lou Moret and Jerry Cantu, both see the bout 80-70. While Judge Ron Scott Stevens sees the bout 79-71. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And still undefeated from Long Beach, California, Emiliano El Revolucion Moreno.
So Emiliano El Revolucion Moreno, the 18-year-old, goes 8 rounds for the first time in his career, gets the decision 6-0. Dropped his opponent twice in the first round and had a battle. I like what I see. A lot to work with, very green, but some talent there.
Yeah, and those scorecards I agree with. Actually, I had it like Ron Scott Stevens. I had that one round for Dominguez. But they don't really, the one-sided nature of those cards don't really tell the story of the fight because the young man had to work very hard
in all
8 rounds.
Yeah, and it was a difficult situation for Dominguez, too, because of the beating that he took in that first round to actually bounce back, take the second round, and be competitive the rest of the way, even though he was losing the succeeding rounds, is a testament in his favor.
Yeah, he lost all those rounds, Dominguez did, but he had moments in all of those rounds.
Stephen Best says, the sponsors paid good money for these commercials. Absolutely. That's why we're able to stream for free. That's why, baby, the commercials. There we go. Or we can charge you. Come on, what do you want? It's free on YouTube and on Facebook. 2 fights done. Coming up next will be Tayden Beltran and Gerardo Fuentes. Let's see what these two young men are talking about.
Here we go, fights fans. Let's get the action going once again. Please welcome out of the red corner from Matamoros, Tamaulipas, Mexico. Here is Gerardo El Boris Puentes.
Matamoros, Mexico. El Boris Gerardo Fuentes. He's got 10 fights underneath his belt.
You know, when I hear music like this,
yeah,
to greet a boxer, it always reminds me of those great Julio Cesar Chavez walk-ins from the dressing room. They seem to take 40 minutes for him to get to the dressing room up to the ring.
Yeah, but they play the long version, thing, right? Yeah. Well, it's not that long of a walk here at the DoubleTree Hotel in Ontario.
And now, please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring out of the blue corner from Huntington Beach, California. Here is Tayden, the Butcher Beltran.
Oh, he's only got a towel? Mike Tyson style?
Well, let me tell you, this guy had his game face on yesterday at the weigh-in. He doesn't smile much.
No.
So he's got a little of that Tyson attitude coming into the ring.
Tayden Beltran, Huntington Beach, 5-0, 3 KOs.
Yeah, look at that face. That's a poker face.
What song is this he's coming out to?
It's different. It's sort of a somber mood.
Is this from like the Modelo commercial?
Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah, you're right. There's a smile.
Yeah. All right. And if anybody's out there, bring me a Modelo. Hey, bring me a Modelo. No? All right. Green room. You guys better have a Modelo. This should be like in Bravehearted, right? Like,
yeah.
Boxing Vitals, what's happening? And he stares at his opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thompson Boxing Promotions continues on with the next bout of the evening. Scheduled for 4 rounds of action in the junior welterweight division. Being sponsored by Makita Tools, Belgard, Omega Products International, and Hustler Casino Los Angeles. Your three judges scoring this bout should it go the distance are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Gerard White. Fight fans, here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stepped in the ring tonight wearing the colors of Mexico. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 137 pounds even. As a professional, his record stands 2 victories against 7 defeats with 1 bout even. 2 of his victories come to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Matamoros, Tamaulipas, Mexico, introducing Gerardo El Boris Fuentes. And introducing his opponent, butting across the ring out of the blue corner. He steps in the ring tonight wearing the black trunks with white. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 136.3 solid pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring undefeated. 5 wins with 0 losses, with 1 bout even. 3 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, from Huntington Beach, California, please welcome Tayden, the Butcher Beltran.
Once again, your referee charges to run up right and give the final instructions.
I'm letting more trim out right here. Let's touch him up and we can go to work, gentlemen.
If you get it, go ahead with the tail.
Yeah, the butcher, he's the taller man, 3 inches taller, and he has the longer wingspan by 2.5 inches.
This should be a good one. He's making his Thompson boxing debut. Look at this old school tattoo.
That's what I was just about to refer to. If you get a chance to take a look at those, those look like Jess Willard and Jack Johnson squaring off 100 years ago.
And shout out to our good friend Jim Boone Tickets, watching us in God's country, as he said, Green Bay, Wisconsin. Of course, you ever need a ticket to a fight, they're never sold out because Jim Boone Tickets got them. And that's not a commercial. That's just my boy right there. He's hooked me up a couple times when I needed something.
He will hook you up.
And good dude. Just awesome guy in Green Bay. All right, so Taden Beltran, the butcher out of Huntington Beach. 5-0, one draw, 3 KOs. From what I was told, he just comes to try to take your head off.
He's a bit of a scary dude. Yesterday, he came in for his pre-fight photos. His nickname had been labeled as The Heat prior to, and that's what they had actually on the box rec reports, et cetera. And
dropping some
Alex Campanova, the matchmaker.
Midsection.
Alex Campanova, the matchmaker here and promoter, said, so your nickname's The Heat. And he just looked up at him real slow and said, no, I am the butcher.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the hook from the butcher. He's sitting on his punches. And yes, this is live on a Friday night. Free boxing on Thompson Boxing. Make sure you download the YouTube and the app.
Butcher's got good technique.
Yeah, moving around. His uncle is Eddie. He used to train Danny Roman.
Oh, that's his uncle?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I recognized Eddie.
By the way, this Beltran, not related to the Beltran that we saw earlier tonight.
Yeah. And
of course, that's a great name in boxing. How many Beltrans have there been?
There's been quite a
dozens
few.
In boxing. Yep.
Including a promoter.
That's right.
Yep. Our Mike's picking up the punches really nice. El Boris is 2-7. But he's a tough 2-7. Is he going to come out there and knock you out? No, but he's going to make it as difficult as possible. From the fights that I've seen, yes, ugly. He knows how to survive and make it tough for you. Got the cupping residue on the back for Beltran. The butcher getting the blood work done. Bouncing around, the butcher. Has a big crowd here, too. A lot of black and red shirts in the crowd at the Doubletree.
Nice head and upper body movement from the butcher. Good punch selection also from Beltran. I like the bounce in his step.
Jared Sanchez, we invest in good microphones here, man. You can hear things. Hear the DJ. You see Amara's V, our ring girl right now. Amara's working. Steven Bass, what's happening? Renee Box Young.
Tonight a little bit unusual in that we opened up with 2 8-round scheduled bouts and now we go to a 4-round.
Yeah, it's different, yeah.
Yeah, because when you sell tickets like Beltran does, you're later on in the card.
Yeah, they move you up. Yeah, they move you up the card.
Like, we ain't trying to lie here.
That's fair. That's fair.
You sell tickets, you're later on in the night.
That's right.
Simple as that. That's why you need to have a good social media account. pounds for Beltran. El Boris, Gerardo Fuentes, weighed at 137. This was scheduled for 4 rounds. After this is going to be Jesse Gonzalez Lobito, then Nelson Oliva, and then our main event, Jesus Saracho and Tarik Zaina.
little extra pep in the step from the Butcher.
All right. Is that a good thing, do you think?
Well, he's showing us that he's relaxed. He feels in control enough of this prize fight that he can showboat a little bit, hot dog a little bit. And, you know, the crowd's appreciating it.
All right, A. Webb says, I swear, my boss is here at the green room. We want a shout out. This is the last shout out I want. You know what? Send me 5 cigars and you'll get a shout out. I can be bought.
Do they have to be Cuban?
Oh, there it is.
It was a right hand to the solar plexus.
That's a good body shot from Beltran.
He's not making a move.
Oh, yeah.
Right at 9, he got up.
He took his time with that. But his reaction, that's how you react when the wind gets sucked out of you. Oh.
Ah,
that was like a liver.
Right back to it. I don't know if he's going to get up. And the corner's going to stop it. The corner has said that's enough, and that is it. Kaden, the Butcher nice. Beltran with a second round stoppage.
Hey, I like this guy.
Let's look at some of the replays.
He's over there dancing now.
Yeah, now he's
body happy. Shots, 2 of them. Right here's the one that ended. Ah.
And this is a typical left, kind of to the liver area, boom. Or maybe it was right below the rib cage.
Woo.
Game over.
He knew what he needed to do after the first knockdown, which was to go right back to the body.
The body work was called. The body work got you. Hustle Casino showed you the body work. We'll be back with more Thompson Boxing on a Friday night in Ontario, California.
Paving the way to your personal sanctuary that you simply can't stop thinking about. Find yours at Bellegarde.com.
Discover the advantages of the Henry Fortifiber 1-2-3 Moisture Control System. It's as simple as 1-2-3. Choose the weather barrier, add the flashing, then finish up with the Henry Moist Top Sealant. Done. No guessing, no gambling. Just the winning confidence you get from our compatible systems.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes. 1 minute, 29 seconds of round number 2. Referee Gerard White puts a stop to this contest, declaring your winner by way of a knockout and still undefeated from Huntington Beach, California, Kaden, the Butcher.
Well, he certainly curried favor with the fans here tonight. And I think those were well-placed warriors on his stomach with
absolutely,
that tattoo.
Absolutely, yeah.
He's a warrior in there.
You know, this is the difference between prospects. In Moreno, Emiliano Moreno, we saw a guy who was 18 years old. Same, around the same number of fights. Emiliano had 5. Tayden has six fights coming in here. But Tayden, at 24 years old, is a little more relaxed. He knows who and what he is in the ring, and he wasn't loading up with every shot. But you don't have to load up. If you have the right shot at the right time, you can get that knockout.
And you see, as you guys were talking, right behind me, El Boris Gerardo Fuentes walked by holding that right side really tight. So it was, you can't say, oh, the guy just stayed down.
Oh, no,
that's five minutes later, the dude is still holding his ribs.
Yeah, Fuentes showed a lot of heart getting up from that first knockdown because that was a short right to his solar plexus, which just takes all the wind out of your body. And he got up, to his credit, but Beltran was really smart to go right back down to the body with a different hand, which I'm sure Fuentes wasn't expecting, and that finished him.
Sultan in Newark, New Jersey. Appreciate you watching us right now. And no, guys don't get paid $150. They're getting paid in the thousands to show up. Come on, man. That's a respect for these guys. Hey, anybody gets in the ring, no matter what, respect to you, no matter your record, because we're in there. They're in there, we're not. So respect to them to get into that ring. And we're going to hear from Tayden Beltran, who's standing with Jessica Rosales.
All right, guys, Tayden Beltran joining me now. He stays undefeated tonight with a pretty impressive knockout that we saw there in the second round. Talk us through that knockout, because it kind of seems like you had that first knockdown and then you knew exactly what to do to end that fight. So talk us through it. We're going to watch it up here on the screen as well.
So let's see. Let's walk, break it down. So is that the second? Yeah, that's the second one, right? So I realized right there I had to calm down a little bit. I knew it was going to come. And then once I calmed down and you saw right there, I landed that left hook to the body. You know, I just saw myself getting a little crazy right there. Shot that one perfect, stayed calm, and it did the job right there. So in that moment, I just realized I had to just be calm, patient, it was going to come.
You know, I think with the calmness, the patience, there was a lot of confidence that you were exuding out there as well. After that first knockdown, were you surprised that he got back up after that one?
Yeah, I actually was. I think he got up right at 9. I thought he was going to be one and done, but I mean, you know, he's tough. He comes from Mexico. Now, don't let the record fool you. Like, he has a lot of experience, you know? So, I mean, he got up, did his thing, but, you know, he's in there with the butcher, so he got to go out. So I had to do that.
True or false? Once you hit him that second time and dropped him, though, you knew that was it, right?
Yeah, I knew that was it. Once he took that, because I got the first one, I got on one side, then I got the other, so I knew he was done after that. So.
Tayden, one of the things that we talked about is the confidence that you had there in the ring. I think that you're a pretty fun fighter to watch, not just while you're actually doing the boxing, but afterwards. You were dancing, interacting with the crowd. I mean, you love what you're doing out there, and it shows. Tell us about that and where that confidence comes from.
I mean, hey, I'm an entertainer, and I know I'm good at what I do, right? So I got to back it up, not just with my hands, but my personality as well. So like I said, I'm here to entertain. I bring a whole crowd of people when they come out to watch me. So, you know, I got to give them a show.
Not just the people that came out here to watch you, but we got a lot of people at home that are watching, whether it's on YouTube, Facebook, our Thompson Boxing app. What do you want to say to all of them for tuning in tonight?
Hey, you know, I just appreciate the support, the love from all the people that are watching for me. And for the new fans that I just gained, I appreciate you as well. Thank you for watching The Butcher Show.
So after tonight's performance, what's next for you?
Hey, well, I'm just going to get right back into the gym. You know, this is a good knockout, but it's not a world title, and that's my goal. So I won't take a rest until I get one of those. So we're back in the gym first thing come Monday. So lining up another fight date.
Tayden, thank you so much for the time. Congratulations on the win tonight.
Thank you. Thank you guys for the support.
Thank you so much. All right, now coming up next, we are ready for that next fight. So we're going to check out Jesus Gonzalez, Levy Garcia. Those two are waiting to walk out to the ring. But first, let's check this out.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get the action going once again. Please welcome out of the red corner as he makes his way to the ring, from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, please welcome Levy Derecho Garcia.
Well, here's another in our lineup of guys making their USA debuts tonight, Doug.
And this young man is unbeaten in his two professional contests.
He's been fighting out down in Guadalajara. 25 years old, which is a little late to only have three pro fights.
Yeah, latecomer.
Especially since they turn him pro in Mexico quite young.
Usually young, yeah. And he's young looking.
And now, please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring. Out of the blue corner, from Santa Ana, California, here is Jesse Lobito Gonzalez.
And Lobito is a guy who's been making his way around the Southern California circuit, fighting in different venues in Costa Mesa, Montebello, here in Ontario.
Yeah, we've seen him before.
Yeah, training with Henry Ramirez in Riverside, born and raised in Santana, but now in the Inland Empire. Got a good record, 6-0-1. From what I was told, it's going to be a good scrap tonight. Our fourth fight, got six total for you tonight.
Well, the last time we saw him was against Papillon, and that was an undefeated fighter, and it was a good scrap.
It really was.
Hellacious.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thompson Boxing Promotions continues on with the next bout of the evening. Scheduled for six rounds of action in the super welterweight division and being sponsored by Westlake Royal Stone Solutions, Thompson Building Materials, Omega Products International, and Infinity Bank. Your three judges scoring the bout should a go the distance are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Thomas Taylor. Fight fans, here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He steps to the ring tonight wearing the burgundy and black trunks. When he steps onto the scale, he weighed officially at 150.6 ready pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring undefeated. Two wins with zero losses, with one about even. Both of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, introducing Levy Derecho Garcia. And introducing his opponent, fighting across the ring out of the blue corner. He stepped in the ring tonight with the black trunks with gold. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed it officially at 150.6 already pounds. Tonight, he too enters the ring undefeated. Six wins with zero losses, with one about even. Two of his victories come to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, the fighting pride of Santa Ana, California, please welcome Jesse Lobito Gonzalez. Once again, referee in charge, Thomas Taylor, with the final instructions.
Okay, belt lines are good on both sides, gentlemen. You got my instructions in the back. Protect yourselves at all times. This is my commands. Touch them up. After corner time.
Tom Taylor, the third man in the ring. Let's look at the tail of the tape for this fight.
Yeah, it all goes Gonzalez's way. He's 4 years younger at age 21, and he has decided height and reach advantages.
All right, so Lobito Gonzalez has Henry Ramirez in his corner. Levy Garcia, derecho, the righty, has Molina in his corner. A trainer that comes in usually on the B side, and always be careful when Molina's in your corner because his dudes come to scrap. You know he's a good trainer, but I don't know his first name. I just know him as Molina. Now, for those of you who know the social media world, you know how Sean Gibbons always brings those crazy Filipinos or those Mexicans that upset everybody? Yeah. That's the kind of guys that Molina brings over. Yeah, so it'll be interesting.
We've seen it. We've witnessed some upsets with his fighters.
So it'll be a good one here. Good test for Lobito Gonzalez. Beto Duran, Doug Fisher, and Rich Murata with you on the live YouTube and Facebook chat. Lobito with an uppercut, and they're coming chucking right away. You don't want to get in a firefight right away, and they said, yes, we do, Beto.
Well, it was a firefight with Papillon. It was a tremendous
battle.
Yes,
it was.
Yeah, that ended up a draw.
That's the mentality that Lobito has. I mean, he's got that wolf in him.
Shout out to Sean O'Connell leaving some fun messages.
He's got these decided height and reach advantages, and he just chucks it.
Well, you know,
it's all been infighting.
I got to disagree. I mean, I'm even disagreeing with our stats are because they showed to a 5-inch height advantage, 5'11 to 5'6, and I don't see that.
Yeah,
out
I don't.
There.
I don't.
They look like they're the same height to me.
I don't think Garcia is 5'6. I think he's 5'9. I do think. Yeah, I do think Gonzalez is taller, though.
Yeah, this will be a good fight. It'll be a good one. That's what I've expected. They're just swinging back and forth. Grampy, I told you, you're better than some of the troll comments you're leaving, man. I want better from you. It's our fourth fight of the night. You're drinking. I expect some good comments here. Let's go. Step it up here.
I'm glad I'm not reading the social media.
Renee Box Young says somebody's getting knocked out. Hey, both fighters with their faces red immediately. With less than a minute to go in the opening round. Wide punches from both fighters. Not much technique at all. Hook and a right hand from the fighter in red, which is Garcia. Levy Josue Garcia.
Yeah, nice.
Well, when you're making that U.S. debut, you don't want to get blown out right away. And he survived that initial onslaught. He's come back pretty good.
Has he come back well enough to take the round?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah. I think Lobito did a little more damage in that opening onslaught. But, man, Garcia is closing
maybe
well.
Maybe he does.
Yeah.
Scheduled for six rounds.
Very good round.
Crayfish, I agree with you. Steven Bass, hey, that's possible. That's Aaliyah, ring girl, this round. Coming up next, Knuckle Nelson Oliva, then our main event, Jesus Saracho. And there he is, Jesus Saracho, desde Guanajuato, Mexico. 13-1, 11 KOs. That's coming up later on tonight in our main event. Sleeper, no, I'm not doing any fights tomorrow. I'm off tomorrow, baby. All right, it's 9:37 Pacific Coast time. I just got my beer delivered to me. I got a Modelo. What are you drinking right now? Let's know. Let's enjoy, and if you were here, you would be buying Doug Fisher a Guinness. He's a Guinness man. Rich, what do you sip on, Rich?
Bottled water, I'm afraid.
That's it?
Very dull.
Perrier Evian?
What is this? Doubletree Ontario water.
Did they used to throw beer at the Forum Boxing?
Oh, among other things. And those beer cups weren't always filled with beer.
Oh,
they were that rowdy, huh? Foreign boxing in the 80s and 90s?
It could get rowdy. But the Olympic Auditorium probably is where the rowdiness took place.
Wish I would have been there just once. For both of them. Remember watching you and the great Tom Kelly on boxing.
That was a great thrill to watch, work with Tom all those years. Yeah. I tell you, he could really command the room.
Do yourself a favor and just YouTube Forum Boxing and you'll see some great fights. Chiquita Gonzalez started there. Paul Gonzalez was there. A lot of Marco Antonio Barrera was there.
Juan Manuel Marquez, Gennaro Hernandez, Mark Dusharp Johnson.
Yeah. Christian Meyer says, Rich Murata, my favorite all-time commentator. Hello from Australia.
Thank you, sir. Wow.
The Aussies know their boxing.
Patrona Nagel with cubed ice. We got some fancy people.
Yeah.
Doug, they said, what kind of Guinness?
Is there any other kind of Guinness? Guinness is Guinness, right? Well, you know, there better not be a Guinness Light out there.
Speaking of those Australians and the fighters, I took a cruise back in the 90s to Australia, and I brought Frankie Duarte, great bantamweight contender, as my guest. He had just lost a heartbreaking decision to Bernardo Panango. I was feeling kind of low. We got off the ship in Australia, and fans came running up to Frankie.
No way. Yeah,
they know, they're real fans.
Speaking of Australia, what about the shot from Tim Zhu last week?
Oh, man.
And Ocampo was a tough dude.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. Timmy's looking like his dad. And I was a huge Costa Zhu fan.
Wow.
Hey, Garcia, yeah, he is good.
Yep, he's winging his punches.
He's a winger.
Landing.
He's a winger, but he times it right. He's accurate with it. He's not sloppy with it.
And, of course, Foreign Boxing, Manitos de Piedra says, Michael Carbajal put on a show there.
The Ruelas brothers,
of course.
Duarte, who I mentioned.
Yep. Yeah, I think Rafael won his lightweight title there.
He did indeed.
Against Freddie Pendleton. Great fight.
Didn't Oscar make his pro debut?
Yes, that's Oscar right. De La Hoya made his pro debut there.
And Garcia from Guadalajara looking good here.
Yeah, we got a firefight.
Max Headroom. Hey, Max, haven't seen you in a while. Jameis is in a pickleback. There you go.
I like that. That sounds good.
And yes, if you're watching this for the first time, we do interact with you. We do just have a conversation. It's a Friday night. Let's go. Way different broadcasts.
If it's your first time hearing our telecast, you might be a little stunned by it. I know I was stunned about the first six times I worked on it.
You too?
Don't be stunned. Join in.
Yeah. It takes some getting used to, but it's fun, and you build a community. Because if you're watching on a Friday night, a YouTube stream, and you're not Tim Boxeo, you are legit hardcore.
Exactly.
So why not engage with you and appreciate you?
That's what it's all about, engagement. Engagement, camaraderie with folks who are as sick of a boxing fan as you are.
And Rich, I'll tell you, the first time we did the stream, I saw the comments and I started interacting with people because they were just ripping the fighters back and forth. So I'm like, you know, I've had enough because these guys are giving their body and their life.
Yeah.
And I went after some of the trolls and I thought I was going to get in trouble for Mr. Ken Thompson, who said, Beto, that's great. Interact with them.
Good stuff.
Have more of them. So it was because of Mr. Thompson who said, hey, keep on doing it.
Mr. Thompson was ahead of his time.
Halifax, Nova Scotia watching us right now, and you're watching 150-pounders go back and forth, just winging punches.
I am pleasantly surprised by Levy Garcia here tonight. He's giving us a terrific account of himself.
He's cool under fire.
So I asked Molina, like, what do we got? And he's very honest. He'll tell me if a guy is here as an opponent or if a guy here is an upset. He's like, this guy has something. Randall Flagg, what's up, man? I didn't ignore the YouTube comments before. It's just the YouTube comments used to be a cesspool, so I would stick to the Facebook comments. And then you guys cleaned it up, so I'm back on YouTube.
There was actually a Levy chant going up here. This is this guy's first fight in the United States.
I think
you can win the crowd.
Yeah, the crowd appreciates what they're seeing. Now, Gonzalez, he might be winning this round just because he's the aggressor and he is landing punches, but Garcia comes back.
This is two-way action.
Ghost MX, we need more jabs. Yeah, right, you're not gonna see one tonight.
Jab is only a distant rumor in this bout.
Stu Mack in Glasgow. Body work, hooks, power shots.
Could be a war of attrition in this one. Because it's been a very hectic pace.
You know, that might favor Garcia because he's a little more economic with his punches. He seems just to be the more settled of the two.
Caín Sandoval, who says, let's go, Lobito, Caín. You're going to fight on a 360 show pretty soon, aren't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, 10-0 with 10 knockouts. Caín Sandoval,
yeah,
good fighter. 140-pound prospect.
Doug works that broadcast for Tom Loeffler on UFC Fight Pass. Fun shows. Coming up next is going to be Knuckle Nelson Oliva. Final seconds of the third round. Crayfish, we appreciate you.
Rounds in, three tough rounds to score.
Yes,
exactly. That round could have gone either way.
The Sonora Dinamita jamming for you here. Doubletree Hotel in Ontario, California. Warp Speed says, Mr. Thompson helped develop champions. Great entertainment. Did nothing but for the love and respect of it all. Of course, rest in peace, Mr. Ken Thompson. And he really did. He was president of the California Boxing Hall of Fame.
The World Boxing.
The World Boxing Hall of Fame, right, based in California. And he really started it, Rich, 23 years ago. Hey, let's get this going. And I always heard, if you want to lose money in boxing, become a promoter. 23 years later, still going.
He had a real love affair with the sport.
Yes. Always here, hours beforehand while they were setting up the ring, sitting ringside for the first time, much like Bob Arum there.
Exactly.
3 o'clock. Mike the Mechanic says, I got Gonzalez losing all three rounds. He's to figure it out. Okay.
I respectfully disagree with that. Gonzalez is bringing it all three of those rounds, and he's landing hard punches. Now, he's getting hit back in return. But I think it's a fight where either guy could be up 2-1.
Lobito may want to talk to Alex Campanovo after that one. He goes, you know, I'm the home guy. I'm supposed to be the house fighter. How about giving me something a little bit easier than Papillon the last time and this guy Levy tonight?
And Alex will tell you, you got to fight your way out of the Doubletree. Sure. Much like Tim Bradley, much like Josito Lopez, much like everybody else, Johnny Gonzalez, you got to get out of here. All right, other people have it 2-1. Wes, all right, what up, Espinoza? I'm going to be in the Newark area end of August. I'm going to come through, bro. Right hand from Levy Garcia. This isn't the kind of fight either guy should be fighting, right?
Well, I would like to see Gonzalez operate a little bit more from a distance. I do think he has the longer reach. He's a little bit taller.
Oh, hell, they're enjoying the combat.
No, we are too. This is what he wants. But the thing is he's got a guy who's very comfortable in the trenches.
Yeah. I'm not complaining about the action, but just at some point you got to say, all right, we need a strategy.
Yeah.
Oh, good one for Lobito. And Molina yelling at his fighter, be first.
Some guys do plan for strategy, but 10 seconds into the fight, that just goes away.
The toughest fight for both of these young fighters. Look at that body shot. Every punch thrown at 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, Garcia winds up, but he's more relaxed. It doesn't look like he's loading up as much as it does when Gonzalez lets his punches go.
By the way, that Benitez on the back of his trunks, that is part of his name. His name is Levy Josue Garcia Benitez.
Well, it didn't fit on the graphics, so we're going with Levy.
Yeah, we had to shorten it up. So.
Our fourth bout of the night. Thank you for interacting with us on the Thompson Boxing. Make sure you hit the like button on the YouTube page. And they both take a deep breath as they go back to the corner.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I have your attention, please. We've located a lost ATM debit card. So if you lost your debit card or ATM card,
Krabby Grampy. Looks like two cabbies fighting for the last burrito.
Oh, wow.
First of all,
problematic right there.
First of all, there's never the last burrito. That joke should have been the last taco. All right, let's get it right. And also, what cabbie do you know exists? We're in 2023. Uber driver, come on, step it up. Krabby, you got to be better with your trolling. I'm disappointed in you tonight. Jose Solis, Doug Fisher kicked me out of House of Boxing in 1999. Let it go.
I bet I did not do that.
1999. Why are you kicking people out, Doug?
I didn't do that. That was somebody else. That was Gary Randall.
Yeah, your earthly account.
That was Steve Kim.
Yeah. Your AOL account was sending spam.
But good callback from that dude. That houseofboxing.com was the website that I had in the late 90s.
Fifth round of action, back and forth between Lovito Gonzalez, Jesse Gonzalez, who's undefeated 6-0 and one with two KOs. And then Levy Josue Garcia Benitez, derecho, righty, 2-0-1, two KOs. Steve Bass, let me just tell you, the Modelo I'm having right now tastes so good. Ghost MX, I'm going to go in person July 21st. I would recommend everybody show up July 21st. We're going to have a good party here in Ontario. Coming up next, Knuckle Nelson Oliva. Man, this is tough.
Yeah. I think Gonzalez is having a decent round, though.
Yep.
He's the more consistent of the two. He's working for 3 minutes of the round, and Garcia is kind of picking his spots. But Garcia's spots are really good. He's effective when he does let his hands go.
That's the voice of Doug Fisher, editor-in-chief of Ring Magazine. Bethel Duran, along with Rich Murata. It is a good club show, good scrap. Kind of Friday night action. When you pay for a ticket, you want to get some back and forth. They're having that.
Yeah, fans are getting their money's worth tonight.
And the judges are earning their money on this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. It's not an easy fight to score. By the way, I have it 38-38 all tied up after four rounds. Yeah, it's anybody's fight on my scorecard.
Make sure you hit the like button on YouTube. Also on Facebook, and share right now.
I think Gonzalez is having a nice round.
Yeah, those were some nice body shots. He's trying to stay in the center of the ring, not get backed up. Although Garcia's doing his best to do that.
The two have been willing to go shoulder to shoulder through much of this fight.
Yeah, they're both comfortable in the trenches.
They're both getting tired, too.
Yeah, you can see fatigue is setting in.
Definitely their toughest fight of their career. And make sure you pick up the latest issue of Ring Magazine. Doug, who's on the cover?
What do you think? Fighters do you think would be on the cover?
Let's see here.
There's an undisputed welterweight championship coming up.
People say it's a big deal.
It's a big fight.
Coming up next, Nelson and Oliva. He's not in the cover.
Not yet.
But it's Spence on the next
That's
cover.
That's right. Errol Spence and Terrence Bud Crawford.
Looking forward to that night. I have to tell you, I enjoyed the atmosphere. It was a good fight, not the greatest fight I've ever seen, but Gervonta Tank Davis, Ryan Garcia had a great atmosphere
It was
an intense fight, and the atmosphere inside the arena was great. I think Spence and Crawford will produce a fascinating, intriguing matchup. And there'll be a lot of atmosphere.
I think it'll have the big fight atmosphere as well, but maybe a more mature crowd, maybe more of a hardcore boxing crowd.
I'm just hoping that that fight delivers. That way the next one could be at a football stadium.
Exactly.
Because that, a few years ago, would have had that thing, but I think we need to see these guys go back and forth.
Exactly.
Sixth and final round between Lobito Gonzalez in black and Levy Garcia in red.
Oh, nice. Nice shots on the inside from Levy. Garcia's got a, he's got a sneaky left hook.
Oh, Lobito overhand right.
Yeah.
There's an uppercut finally.
And see, that punch knocked all the sweat off of Garcia's head, snapped the head back. The judges take notice of one shot.
And it
like
forced
that.
Him to give ground. He took three steps back after that one.
So on the inside, Garcia had landed some nice left hooks, but Lobito covers up, and those punches don't move him that much, but Gonzalez lands some shots that knock Garcia off balance, knock him back a few steps, and the judges take notice of that.
Meantime, in another part of the arena here tonight, Emiliano Moreno, who was a victor tonight and had a big cheering section, is over taking pictures with every single person in his cheering section over there.
As he should.
He earned it. He earned it.
Ryan Thompson, good for you, bro.
These fighters right here are earning it. Win, lose, or draw, these guys are earning their money.
Levy Garcia loading up with his right hand.
Winging from a Jalisco. Steven Bass, Crawford wins by KO. Ghost MX, Earl's going to crack Crawford. That's what I love. You can see both of those happening. That's why this fight's so good.
It's a 50-50 fight. You can make a great case for either guy. They're obviously the two best welterweights in the world. Both guys are rated in everybody's top five pound for pound. They're the two most accomplished fighters in the 147-pound division. Obviously, it's for all the marbles. It's just it's a tremendous, fascinating matchup.
Jesus Padilla says, the rematch could be at Cowboy Stadium. Absolutely.
Yeah. I always felt that first Canelo Triple G fight should have been at Cowboy Stadium.
We worked it. We should have been. This has been a fun back and forth scrap to two young fighters. To borrow that tire cliche, it's been a phone booth fight.
Yep. I'm really impressed with Garcia's effort in this final round.
Wow.
He's emptying the tank.
And Gonzalez, Garcia, let the hands go. The way the fight started is the way it is.
Boy, they were really digging in there at the end.
That's all. Cheers for me right here. Respect to these fighters.
Yeah.
On a Friday night,
good
putting
fight.
Up action.
You know, they fought right through that fatigue you referred to in
the
fourth round.
Yeah.
And there you see Molina. He feels like his fighter got it. We'll come back with the decision. What are we going to have? Thompson Boxing on a Friday night.
If you're at this table, you know that it's more than a game of luck. You're not here for the small talk. You're here for the action. If you're at this table, you're a hustler. Hustler Casino.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of boxing action, to the judges' scorecards we go. Judge Dr. Lou Morenzi is about 60 to 54. Judge Jerry Cantu sees it 59 to 55. While Judge Ron Scott Stevens sees about 62 to 58, all in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, Levy Derecho Garcia.
He comes in as an opponent. We told you Molina always has something up his sleeve.
That's a Molina special.
There it is. Levy Josue Garcia Benitez gets the victory in his U.S. debut. For me, the scorecard's really wide.
Yeah, I saw
it
very
close from that.
Yeah, I had it a draw, 57 to 57, three rounds apiece. I'm not mad at Garcia winning that fight because the dude came here and fought his ass off.
I thought he deserved the decision, and as I said, I was very pleasantly surprised. 58 to 56, we understand, was the last. Was the last
58-56 was the last part.
Right.
Got it.
Yeah. Okay. 62 didn't quite make sense. But
so
yeah.
That was the that was a much more reasonable score.
I agree with that. Yeah. That's a fair scorecard.
I certainly didn't see it as a shutout.
Right.
And I thought he fought very well. I was pleasantly surprised because we just didn't know what to expect.
No.
You know, from Levy. He comes in here with three fights in Mexico. We hadn't seen him. We hadn't seen tape of him.
No,
so,
but from the opening round, one thing that struck me was his calm under fire. Nothing really rattled him. He seemed more settled than Gonzalez. Gonzalez gets very keyed up. He's very tense. He's bouncing up and down, and he's kind of forcing it a little bit too much. Garcia just he laid back, and he let those hands go with fluidity.
Yeah, so 58-56 was the final card.
That makes sense.
And California Commission made sure to come over and tell us what it was. So good job. Hey, he came in, did what he had to do. And it was a tough fight.
Hey, great effort to Lobito. Like I said at the start of this broadcast, this is part of the developmental process. To get to where Jesus Saracho is, sometimes you got to take a loss, just like Saracho did.
Yeah, it is. Y saludos a todos los que están mirando Guadalajara, Jalisco, México. No se vayan porque ahorita van a entrevistar a su peleador en el derecho, Levy Garcia. Jessica Rosales, let's hear your Espanol.
All right, guys, thanks for joining us right now. We have Levy Garcia. Levy, let's talk about the fight, and did you expect this type of fight? Si me puedes decir un poco de esta pelea, ¿fue el tipo de pelea que estabas esperando?
Sí, mira, fue una pelea bastante dura. Sabíamos que no íbamos con un rival fácil. El Lobito es un rival muy, muy fuerte. Tiene una pegada muy fuerte, su gancho es muy fuerte, pero nos preparamos muy bien en el gimnasio. Y el resultado fue el que esperábamos. Gracias a Dios nos llevamos la victoria a México. Eso fue lo en lo que estuvimos trabajando. Y pues nada, agradecer a mi familia, a mi entrenador y a todos los que siempre me han apoyado en este deporte.
All right. He said that of course tonight he did not face an easy rival, that they were expecting him to be very difficult, that he is someone who is a very hard puncher, and they were expecting all of that, but of course they did get the results that they were hoping for, and that's to take the victory back to Mexico. And he wants to say thank you to everybody who has supported him, including his family. And you know, if you can tell me tonight about Lobito Gonzalez, obviously it was very back and forth all night long. What for you really sealed the victory?
Pues fue una pelea super duro. Estaban, you know, muy cerca y fue una pelea que estaban, you know, enfrente y boxeando toda la noche. Para ti, ¿qué fue el momento en que tú supiste que estabas ganando esta pelea?
Sí, mira, fue muy parejo. Lobito también tira muchos golpes, pero como te lo dije, nos preparamos para una pelea desde un inicio, darlo todo. Venimos con esa sed de ganar. De Dios quiera más adelante estar peleando por un título mundial, y pues ese es el objetivo que todo boxeador tiene, ser campeón del mundo, y pues aquí estamos echándole ganas. Ojalá nos permitan seguir peleando aquí y sumar más victorias para llegar por ese título.
He said that, of course, this fight was a very close fight, that both of the fighters were throwing a lot of punches.
But of course, this is the type of fight that he did train for and that hopefully in the future he is able to fight for a world title. That's what every boxer is hoping for as a goal, is to fight for a world title, and he hopes to continue to get that opportunity in the sport. Levi, pues felicidades en esta victoria esta noche. ¿Le quieres decir algo a toda la afición que tienes que están mirando esta noche?
Sí, claro que sí. Primeramente quiero, a los que tenían duda que era esto, mi hijo estaba muy preocupado. Del Día del Padre me dio este amuleto de la suerte. Le dije que mientras lo portara yo, me iba a traer mucha suerte. Gracias a Dios, mira, nos llevamos la victoria. Le mando un beso grande a mi hijo, a mi esposa y a toda mi familia, que ellos siempre me han apoyado, y a toda la gente que siempre me ha apoyado en este deporte. Muchas gracias.
¿Cómo se llama tu hijo?
Lian Benítez, Lian García, perdón.
So, what he said is when I gave him the opportunity to say thank you to all of his fans, he told me about his son, Leon, who gave him this right here. Now, this is for good luck. He said that his son was very worried for him and going into this fight, that for Father's Day, he made a little amulet for good luck to wear at the fight. And, you know, he said, of course, he came out with the victory tonight. And he wants to thank his son for that and thank his family for supporting him. Pues, Levi, felicidades. Muchas gracias por el tiempo esta noche.
Muchas gracias a ti. Hasta luego.
All right, guys, so that was a very interesting, very sweet gesture from his son to give him that little amulet for good luck. But coming up next, we do have our co-main event, Knuckle Nelson and Miguel Angel Barajas. They're ready to walk into the ring, but first, let's check out this video.
Here we go, fight fans. Let's get the action going once again. Now, please welcome out of the red corner as he makes his way to the ring from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. Here is Miguel Angel Barajas.
Miguel Angel Barajas. There you hear Vicente Fernandez, Guadalajara, coming in. 3-3, he's tough. Mike is his name.
Have we seen him before?
Yes, we have.
He looks real familiar.
Tough dude.
Tough, kind of awkward.
Oh, kind of.
Kind of, okay, yeah.
Yeah, one way to put it.
He is not a young kid fighting here at the Doubletree, though. He's 34 years old.
Mikey is his nickname.
And now please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring out of the blue corner from Los Angeles, California. Here is Knuckle Nelson Oliva.
Ow! He's getting comfortable fighting here at the Doubletree.
Yeah.
Knuckle Nelson Oliva.
You recognize the music?
What you got?
What?
What are you saying, Doug?
I don't know.
Oh, I thought you knew.
You.
No.
Come on. Yeah. I'm the classic rock guy.
Well, don't worry.
Or the
me.
Heavy metal guy.
I thought it was like a song that you knew or something.
No. Well, what style of music is this? What do you call it? Cumbia?
No. This is like bachata kind of. The name of the song is called La Vaca, the cow.
Oh, okay.
This is a quinceañera jam.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, from the Doubletree Hotel in Ontario, California, Thompson Boxing Promotions is proud to present the co-main event of the evening, scheduled for 6 rounds of action in the middleweight division, and being sponsored by Makita Tools, Bellguard, Omega Products International, and Hustler Casino Los Angeles. Your three judges scoring this bout should it go the distance are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Gerard White. Fight fans, here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He steps in the ring tonight wearing the black trunks. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 159.5 ready pounds. As a professional, his record stands 3 victories against 3 defeats, 2 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, introducing Miguel Angel Barraza. And introducing his opponent, fighting across the ring out of the blue corner. He steps in the ring tonight wearing the white trunks with orange. When he stepped onto the scale, he went in officially at 159.5 solid pounds. Tonight, he enters the ring undefeated. 6 wins with 0 losses. 5 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, hailing from Los Angeles, California, here is Knuckle Nelson Oliva. Once again, you're in charge. Gerard White, give the final instructions.
Nelson, yeah, we're going to be rules in the dressing room. You both know what I expect out of you. The trunks are good here. The trunks are good here. Let's go to work.
Oliva at 27 is 7 years younger. He's 3 inches taller, but Barajas has half an inch in wingspan.
So Nelson Oliva, just to clarify, my man in the 559 text me, Beto, come on now. It's merengue. He came into merengue.
Merengue. That's what, yeah.
Knuckle Nelson.
I couldn't remember. Yeah, usually it's like Dominican fighters, yeah, right? Little, you see coming into the merengue and stuff, that kind of fits.
Well, Knuckle Nelson is from Guatemala. That's
right?
Where his family has roots. He's a construction worker working, help build the 10 freeway, some of the area out there towards Coachella.
Yo, he's built like a construction worker. Look at the dude.
He actually did, if you see social media, he did a video promoting this fight where he had the iron. He was on the iron with the big hammer.
Oh, yeah.
I told him, do that stuff,
yeah,
man. That,
I think that's smart. I love it when he goes to the body. Yeah.
He's a union man a la Joe Smith.
Yes.
Work it.
Yeah.
Get the backing.
Get the blue collar effect, man. Yeah.
And the guy can crack 6-0, 5 KOs. And Mikey, who's usually rough and tumble, he'll get in with you. He's keeping his distance in this fight. I think he felt something right away.
Knuckle blew through his first 5 opponents with KOs in all of them. Only fought 7 rounds in those first 5 fights. And I remember 2 or 3 fights ago, I did talk to him after the show. I said, you know, they're not all going to be that easy for you in the future. He said,
this one is.
Yes.
He went to the hook upstairs, body shot, followed, and Mikey down. Gets up at 9.5.
Clean
really
body.
Really close. Halfway through the opening round.
Plenty of time for Knuckle Nelson.
You know, it's really funny when you talk to him, he says, I really don't go for the KO. He goes, I just go out there to
fight. I don't know about that. I think he goes for it.
He is right now.
I'm not mad at him for that.
No, that's a co-main. Let's go. And Mikey gets hit on the temple.
Oh, his equilibrium is off.
He got hit right on the temple.
And that's what it does. It makes you dizzy.
One more and he's done. Less than a minute to go in the first round.
Looks like a new knockout streak is going to start tonight. His last fight, though, went the distance.
Yep.
That was Wayne Boudreau.
That was a good fight with
boy.
The guy from the Bayou.
Yeah, Wayne gave him a real
good fight. Another body shot. That's going to do it. There it is. A first round KO for Knuckle Nelson. He's now 7-0, 6 KOs.
He's got to stop telling us he's not going for the
All right.
Yeah,
I'm not buying it.
We'll be back. Knuckle Nelson. Easy work on a Friday.
Experience the world's largest compatible cordless system. Makita's LXT batteries take you from power tools to outdoor power equipment. The blower delivers power comparable to a 24cc gas model. From the job site to your home, reach speeds of 116 miles per hour. Use Makita's cordless products anytime, anywhere. One system, endless possibilities. Now get two extra free batteries.
Paving the way to your personal sanctuary that you simply can't stop thinking about. Find yours at Bellegarde.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes. 2 minutes, 25 seconds of round number one. Referee Gerard White puts a stop to this contest, declaring your winner by way of a knockout and still undefeated from Los Angeles, California, Knuckle Nelson Oliva.
And happy birthday to Knuckle Nelson Oliva. Knocked his opponent down three times. Henry wants the picture. Henry Ramirez asking for the picture. Yeah. At the merengue jam.
He's Moran. That's how you dance the merengue.
Make sure you follow Henry on Instagram. You will see this posted. He'll have a nice, he does a good job promoting his fighters. And let's look at the final knockdown brought to you by Hustle Casino. Was it a body shot that got him?
Yep. Oh. Yeah. Left to the body. Left is his power hand.
He pinpointed that one.
Yes, he did. Sometimes it's straight to the midsection. Other times it's to the rib cage. Other times it's to the liver.
But that's what you got to do when you've already hurt the guy to body shots earlier. Go right back to it.
You know, that attack, it looked really like he knew. I mentioned he's pinpointed it. He looked like he knew what he wanted to do and was had and threw those punches with purpose.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
Well, I think Mikey, is it Mickey or Mike?
Both.
Mikey, he usually has a pretty strong beard. He take a shot to the head, so it made sense to attack that body.
Yeah. Here's the reason it's both, because I've heard him say, and Mikey, and then I heard his corner say Mickey.
Yeah.
So it's like, so we will be hearing from Oliva on his birthday, as he's with Jessica Rosales. One more fight to go. Don't go anywhere. Make sure you share on YouTube and on Facebook. And let's go to Jessica Rosales, who's standing by with the birthday boy.
All right, guys. Joining me now, we got Knuckle Nelson up here at our news desk. First off, Nelson, you told me you walked up here. I said, how are you feeling? Good? And you said, I'm feeling great. So tell us about that quick and easy night for you, huh?
You know what? It's never an easy night. There's always so much work that goes to this. Most of my camp was out of the city. I didn't see my baby, I didn't see my girl. Because I work and making the sacrifice to earn money and do this. But I keep on pursuing boxing, doing what I do. I love what I love to do, and hopefully one day you'll see me on a big stage making more money and doing what I love.
So what we're going to do right now is we're going to take a replay of that knockout. So you're going to be able to see it on our screen right here. Talk us through that moment.
You know what? Each knockdown was more of a body shot. He would have a high guard, so the only place to aim is the body. Yeah.
Of course, let's talk a little about your opponent because, you know, not an easy opponent that you were in there with tonight. Did you expect this fight to end so quickly, or were you expecting more of a fight from him?
No, I expected more of a fight. I know each fight that he's been in has been tough. My coach warned me he's a free swinger. He always comes out swinging back. But I was just being real careful, just picking my shots and taking what he gave me.
And now that we've got the boxing talk out of the way, listen here. You didn't tell us that today is kind of an important day for you. Do you want to tell them what today is, or should I spill the beans? All right, I'm going to spill the beans. Carolina came over to me. Who's Carolina? Why don't you explain to them?
My mom's Carolina, my number one fan.
All right, his mom came over to me, and not only did she tell me it's your birthday today, she handed me this wonderful sign that all of your friends and family autographed for you, and it says, happy birthday. They've all signed it for you. I even signed it right here, okay? That's me.
Oh, okay.
He said who. That's my signature right there. So this is the first time you're getting to see this. It's your birthday. Look at... They're singing happy birthday, you guys. We gotta listen to this.
Happy birthday, dear Nelson. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Okay. I put you on the spot there, but let's talk about the support that you're getting from your friends, your family, the community. This has got to feel really great, especially on your birthday.
Oh, yeah, man. Everyone watching me on YouTube, everyone here always shows 100% support. And they know I work hard for it. I'm going to keep working hard for it. Just keep on grinding every day. Keep on doing what I do. Keep on enjoying what I do. And never losing the passion I have for this.
Now the real question is, how are you going to go and celebrate not only the win tonight, not only the KO tonight, but also the birthday?
What I do every single fight, I go for an 8-mile run.
Wow, that sounds real fun right about now. All right, so what's next for you, Nelson?
We'll see. Got to work with my manager, my trainer, but just stay ready. Stay ready because anything's a possibility. Looking forward for what's next and just staying ready, man. I got to stay ready.
Do me a favor because we've got the camera over here. Turn around one more time to this crowd. They're going to go wild. Watch this. All right. You got to love that. Happy birthday, Nelson. Congratulations on the win tonight.
Thank you. Thank you for everyone watching. I appreciate it. I'll see you next time.
Thank you so much. And shout out to his mom, Carolina. She's so cute. His mom was so adorable. She came over and she was like, you've got to present him with this sign. So I loved that. Your mom is the cutest ever. All right, guys, we got a lot more coming up, including our main event. So right now we're going to send it to Sunny inside the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention, please. I would ask that you please rise at this time. Please rise from your seats, remove your caps, and remain absolutely silent in observance of our nation's anthem to be presented by recording artist Miss Aries Kay.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed and the twilight's last gleaming whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get the action going once again. Please welcome out of the red corner as he makes his way to the ring from Tijuana, Mexico. Here is Tarik Sandstorm Zaina.
All right, Rich, this is your guy. Let us have it. Who is this guy?
This is a guy from Gibraltar, but I guess Gibraltar, the Rock of Gibraltar.
The Rock of Gibraltar. Okay.
He could claim many homes, I guess, because he went and lived in England for quite a while, attended the University of Leeds, bachelor's degree, master's degree. When COVID hit, he left England, and he came to Mexico on his own. Without a promoter, without a manager, without anybody. He came to Mexico because Mexico was more open. There was some, he could train, he could get some fights, and
it's a real leap of faith. That's a real leap of faith.
Oh, it absolutely is. Well, he feels he's on a big journey and that he's destined for greatness. We're anxious to see him here tonight.
I can guarantee you this is the first time we've ever had Khalid Belsik enter song here on Thompson Boxing. So the man from Gibraltar. Hey, welcome to Thompson Boxing. Sonny Franco, who's he fighting?
And now, please welcome his opponent as he makes his way to the ring out of the blue corner from Guanajuato, Mexico. Here is Jesus Saracho.
I think we're all a little disappointed in Jesus because he weighed in at 143.7. The contracted weight for this fight was 140. This is a WBO Latino title fight, and he had the title and he lost it on the scales. Now that means that Tarik can win it if he is a winner tonight, but Jesus Saracho has lost the title on the scales.
So that belt that they're holding, he's not eligible to win it tonight, correct?
That's correct.
It's a WBO Latino belt. Tigres del Norte, Jefes de Jefes.
Yeah.
He comes from Guanajuato, an area in central Mexico where Robinson Castellanos.
Oh, I remember him.
Remember Robin Hood?
That guy, yeah, he had a bad record, but he could fight.
He had bad record?
Dangerous.
Unless you were a former champion or something.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thompson Boxing Promotions is proud to present the feature attraction as this is the main event of the evening. Sponsored by Thompson Building Materials, transforming spaces into beautiful places with location throughout California. By Westlake Royal Stone Solutions, stone veneers that redefine versatility. By Omega Products International, the leading stucco manufacturer in the USA. And by Belgard, Belgard paves the way. By Makita, rule the outdoors. And last but definitely not least, by Hustler Casino, LA's only luxury casino. And is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission, Executive Officer Andy Foster, Chairman John Caravalli, Inside the ring, supervisor for the WBO, Mr. Gino Rodriguez. Your three judges scoring this championship bout, should it go the distance, are Dr. Lou Moret, Jerry Cantu, and Ron Scott Stevens. Timekeeper, Keenan Wright. Ringside physicians, James Brown and Tariq Khan. And last but not least, the man in charge of the action at the bell, your referee, Thomas Taylor. 10 rounds of action for the WBO Latino Junior Welterweight Championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the DoubleTree Hotel in Ontario, California, where battles are fought and champions are made, ladies and gentlemen, let the battles begin! Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, he stepped the ring tonight with the black trunks with gold. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 139.8 already pounds. As a professional, he enters the ring tonight undefeated. 12 wins with 0 losses. 8 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, de Baja California, Tijuana, Mexico, introducing Tarik Sandstorm Zaina. And introducing his opponent, fighting in the blue corner. He stepped in the ring tonight with the white trunks with red. When he stepped onto the scale, he weighed in officially at 143.7 pounds. As a professional, he has 14 fights to his credit, including 13 victories against 1 defeat. 11 of his victories coming to you by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the former WBO Latino Junior Welterweight Champion from Guanajuato, Mexico. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Jesus Saracho. Once again, your referee in charge, Thomas Taylor, give the final instructions.
Okay. Coach, belt line's a little high here, so we're going to go top of the numbers, right? Belt line's good here. Both belt line instructions in the back. Protect yourselves at all times. This is the main stage.
Saracho, 7 years younger at age 21. Zaina with a decided height advantage. He is 3 inches taller. Zaina also has 1 inch in wingspan.
All right, so is it Gibraltar or Gibraltar?
Like a J.
J. Yeah, Gibraltar.
Yeah, like the Rock of Gibraltar.
It's a British territory by Spain. It's on the border. Right. So he speaks Spanish as well, English, and you said 2 other languages, Rich?
Yes, he speaks English, Spanish, French, and Arabic.
Yeah, he's of Moroccan descent, so that's where you're going to get the Arabic and the French.
All right, so if you saw Rich in his corner is Joel Diaz. And I thought Joel was just, working cuts, because at a Thompson show, sometimes people need somebody. So I was like, Joel, you're working cuts? He said, no, I trained this kid.
Oh,
like, you do?
Yeah.
He's like, a month ago, he showed up at his gym.
Right. Oh, he's been in Indio training. Although, when he relocated to Mexico, he first went to Eric Morales' gym down there. But then after a short time, he settled in at the gym, Arias, Guillermo Arias, has the gym, and that's been the guy who's been training him, and he gives a lot of credit to him. But now he came up here and he hooked up for this fight with Joel Diaz, although Arias is here tonight.
Yeah, so Arias is his guy. So for the last month, Gabriel, who's in his corner also, they used him, and for Joel's training camp, he was sparring all the Russians there. So I was like, Joel, he got something? He's like, this kid's got something. Okay, so
that's another leap of faith, though, from Tijuana to Indio.
Yeah. And for Saracho, the southpaw, Rich, you were at the weigh-in yesterday. What was that like? He missed weight, but was it like an argument, or was this guy? What was going on over there?
No, it was a very matter of fact. He got up there, and they informed him, you're going to lose this portion of your salary and that you're making tonight, and your opponent is going to get a portion of it.
Yeah.
Oh. And
those are California rules.
20%.
Yeah. That wouldn't happen in another state or jurisdiction.
So there was nothing like, okay, you can try to look, because he was so heavy.
Yeah, and there was no attempt to take it off. I mean, that was
You know, they didn't give him. They didn't give him like an hour to. Yeah, but no, he missed it by
over 3 pounds.
They don't want. Yeah, they don't want fighters to try to sweat out that much.
If you're 2 pounds, you could try to lose it. If you're over that, California commissioner said no. You just pay the fine.
Yeah, California is really strict on the weight regulations.
Rambling Ralph Velez in Arizona. What up, Ralphie? Says hello to Dougie and Richie. This is our main event, 10 rounds scheduled in the 143 and 139. And Saracho from Guanajuato, Mexico. I'm used to saying Guadalajara. Y solo toda la gente en Guanajuato nos está mirando esta noche.
But as we mentioned on the pre-fight comments at the start of the show tonight, all of the great story that is Tarik Zaina here, can he fight? That's the question.
So we got to figure out. Luki Boxing. Make sure everybody go buy Luki's book. Does a great job covering the sport of boxing in the Bay Area. Yeah, we've seen a lot of fighters that lose their belt on the scale. Joshua Franco, as a matter of fact, in Japan, 6 pounds over.
Yeah, wow. That was disappointing.
Thompson Building Materials all over Southern California. Go to thompsonbldg.com.
Even Jose Luis Castillo was never that much overweight.
Yo, Doug, this is a question from Roger Boxy MMA. If a fighter misses weight, does he still have to pay the sanctioning fee?
That's a good question.
Huh. Where's the WBO guy?
The guy, if he loses it on the scale, I don't think he has to.
Because there's only one guy.
The other guy does.
All right, Luki is giving us the scouting report on Saracho. He's like a blender. He gets you on the ropes. He creates chaos. Throws 6 to 8 wide punches, but defense not included. All right.
Defense not included. I like that.
All right.
Good one, Luki.
Well, I think he's a grinder. You know, that's how I would describe him. A southpaw grinder. He's not dazzling.
Right.
But he keeps a tight guard. He usually has his right hand up in a good defensive stance.
Yeah, I think he has solid fundamentals. He's just not like super dynamic. You know, nothing jumps out at you, but he gets the job done. I consider him a real prospect despite that one loss because of the quality of his opposition. He's faced a lot of unbeaten and once beaten opponents.
Yeah, his last two fights have been wins over unbeaten opponents. He fought a 12-0 guy and then a 10-0, Nick Jefferson.
Yeah, that lets you know that he and his management, they're confident.
Y saludos a toda la gente de Guanajuato y la familia Saracho, como del primo Miguel Ángel.
I think it might take a round or two for Saracho to warm up, though, then really cut the ring off on Zaina.
Shout out to Watsonville, Victor Jimenez in Irapuato, Guanajuato.
I tell you what, you can tell that Saracho has the power in this matchup. His punches are just much heavier.
I was talking, not to drop names, but one of the great,
please do.
one of the great boxing writers and authors of many books, Jerry Eisenberg. I was talking to him earlier today on the phone, and I was telling him the Tarik Zaina story, and he was really inquisitive about him, and he asked me to please call him tomorrow and let him know how he does, if he could fight or not, because he thought it was a tremendous story.
How did he get into boxing? Did you know that, Rich? I was trying to find out anything. I couldn't find anything.
Well, he started boxing at the age of 14, and it was at the age of 18 that he moved to England. And he had quite an amateur career at that point while he was going to the University of Leeds.
Yeah, there's a good amateur system in England.
Fantastic.
In every major city.
I didn't expect it from Gibraltar, though.
No, but there have been great fighters of Moroccan descent.
Oh, yes.
Eisenberg probably covered a lot of
I will say there's one thing, though. There's only one person who has actually seen the passport and seen those 50 countries,
on this broadcast crew.
Yeah, that was me.
Doug Fisher.
Yeah.
I met
Tarik the day of the Chocolatito Gonzalez, Jose Cesar Martinez fight in San Diego.
And he showed you his passport?
Yeah, he asked me, have you ever covered a fighter from Morocco? I said, I don't think so. He said, have you ever covered a fighter from Gibraltar? And I said, definitely not. And he said, one day you will. And here I am. And here he is.
How about that? He came up to you and said that?
Yeah, and I didn't even think he was a fighter. I just thought he was a fan or somebody.
Yeah. So he knew who you were.
Media. Yeah, yeah.
Our next show, Friday, July 21st. Make sure you're here at the DoubleTree Hotel in Ontario. 50 countries.
And he is the first pro boxer from Gibraltar.
And then, silly me, I say, man, you traveled all that way?
No, I'm in TJ. I'm like, okay, that makes more sense.
Yeah, because Tijuana stayed open during the pandemic.
Yeah.
He was actually considering, he was trying to make up his mind where he would go. And he considered Germany, and he considered, this one caught me out of the blue, Kazakhstan. It was either going to be Germany or Kazakhstan or Mexico. But then he said, you know, I ended up deciding between Mexico City and Tijuana.
Usam Jam says, bias commentary, no appreciation on Tarik's work. We've been talking about Tarik for the first two rounds, bro.
I think he's won the first two rounds.
Yeah.
Tarik. There, how's that?
Man,
I think he's boxing really well. I think Saracho is showing that he's dangerous, but he just hasn't been able to get like a consistent offense going.
Azteca Boxing Club in Seattle, what's happening? Fred Lee? Fred, where are you at? Irapuato, Guanajuato, I'm in Celaya. People watching us from all over. I know it's breakfast time for some of the people watching us across the pond. It's cool, Usam. We're all right.
Interesting stance that Zaina has. As he keeps that left hand down low, he's got that long, lean body. He lunges sometimes with his jab, which could possibly get him in trouble.
Webb, there's no way you're leaving. You've been commentating since the first fight tonight. It's the main event. You're not going anywhere, man. Come on. You got a good one here. Steve Bass says, I see Saracho coming on.
Okay. Stop. Saracho's trying. He's trying to get it going.
Also, when you miss weight that bad and you were trying and you're drained, you're not trying to go the distance in your fight.
Right.
Well, Saracho said he's been in the gym all 5 months since his last fight in January.
Tell you what, though, Zane is making him swing and miss a lot. And that'll tire a fighter out quick.
Benjamin says, I'm watching from England and I live with Tarik and TJ. All right. Yeah, tea and crumpets across the pond.
I just think that's such a real brave thing that he did, coming by himself to Mexico.
Dude, and not knowing anything going, and then you're going to Eric Morales' gym? I mean, Zona Norte?
Right. Yeah.
Jeez.
That's kind of a rough area, eh?
Yeah. That's just inside the gym.
Yeah, right.
Good movement there from Zaina.
Yeah, Zaina's really elusive. And it's not just with the lateral movement. He's got the head. He's got the upper body movement.
And if he lands the right punch, he can be powerful. I saw him knock out Daniel Valenzuela while he was laying against the ropes with one punch, a counter left hook.
Our main event. Thompson Boxing in Ontario, California on a Friday night. Thank you for joining us as we head to the fourth. We got any boxing this weekend?
Yeah, we've got Edgar Belanga versus Jason,
our guy.
Our good friend Jason Quigley in New York City. We have Carlos Adames versus Julian J-Rock Williams.
Oh, that's right, in Minnesota.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, those will be fun fights.
That's an interesting J-Rock coming back. Haven't seen him in a while.
And awesome. At a new weight. He's
risen from junior middleweight to middleweight.
Okay. And also Caleb Truex on the card. He's coming back. Of course, Minnesota fight.
He's going to sell the tickets. Yeah.
Berlanga, what's the deal on him? He just signed a Matchroom.
Yeah, I don't know.
He's really polarizing, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. Dude, I mean, there's something there. There's something to work with, but he's not unbeatable, that's for sure.
Yeah, Puerto Rican fighter fighting in New York. Quigley, big underdog. We'll see
He is.
After getting blown out by Boo Boo Andrade.
Yeah.
It's been, you know, it's just been a really solid year for boxing, in my opinion. I think it's been one of the best years that we've had in recent years, and done it without the heavyweights, you know, without the heavyweights being involved in big fights.
Yeah, they've sat out. All the elite level heavyweights have just sat out.
Oh, that's right. Jerwin on Gahouse is on the card, too.
Yeah, that's an IBF 115-pound title bout against the guy from Argentina.
There's a show in Phoenix. Trevor McCombie is back.
I remember Trevor McCombie. Light heavyweight.
Yeah, Rambly Ralph says 26-0, 22 KOs.
Yeah, good dude, Trevor. I may have called his pro debut, as a matter of fact.
Yeah. Good left landed by Saracho.
Yeah, Saracho was starting to find the range, and he needs to. I got him losing the first three rounds.
I think Saracho's game plan is going for the knockout. He's just been sluggish.
Yeah, he's been landing in this round. He's been landing the straight left to the chest.
I think Zaina's punching with a little more intent in this round. Although he may have been outfought in this round.
Yeah, so far a decent round for Saracho. But we're just at the midway mark.
Yeah, Arias Gym in Tijuana. Good spot for fighters.
He's very respectful of Guillermo Arias.
And so that's this weekend. Next weekend, Virgil Ortiz, Stenionis.
Oh, yeah.
In San Antonio.
Yeah, that's going to be awesome.
Good to see Virgil back.
Actually, that'll be a couple of weeks. I think
2 weeks.
I think Ortiz Stenionis is July 8th.
Yeah. Oh, good body shots upstairs from Saracho.
Yeah, it was a nice right cross to the ear landed by Zaina.
Webb, let you know, man, Newark, New Jersey. I'm going to be out there at the end of August. My son is going to be going to school out there, so I got to drop him off in Madison. So I'm coming through, baby. This is a good main event here.
Yeah, it's an interesting clash of styles. I think Saracho's had a good round, in part because Zaina has planted his feet more. Woo, that was a nice right hand. Landed by Zaina. I feel like Saracho's landing his power punch more in this round than Zaina is.
Boxing in San Francisco at the Cow Palace tomorrow. Andy Ventus, Fernando Vargas Jr.
Cow Palace.
Evan Holyfield. G-Fund Boxing, let me know. Steve Bash, good commentary, man. I really like your observations in this fight. Good work, man. Nancy Lopez, I see you. You're right. Memo Arias.
Well, we had our eyes on Saracho in his corner. Joel Diaz, meantime, was very animated and very verbal with Zaina in that corner.
Yeah, gave him a light slap.
Yeah, a little some.
Yep.
Real Ernie Green finally got to watch it. He's here for the main event, host of the chat on Friday nights.
What's up, Ernie?
He had a baseball game tonight, so he's late. Hey, but that's the beauty. You can always go back and watch the earlier fights on the Thompson Boxing YouTube page available for you.
Video on demand.
All right, so we're done with four. Let's check out the unofficial scorecard of Doug Fisher. What do we got, Dougie?
I thought Zaina was boxing very well in the opening three rounds, but Saracho kind of worked his way back in. I scored round four for Saracho.
Yeah, but that little slap from Joel Diaz has seemed to have reawakened Zaina in this round.
Yeah, he probably told him to get back on the stick and move game a little bit more, but also to go out there and get some respect.
Zaina's got a good right hand. It's very quick, and it's real sharp when he lands.
PR Pro San Diego, make sure you follow Gail. Does an excellent job covering the sport of boxing, writing for New York Fights and amongst other publications. She's watching right now, of course.
Yeah, Gail does a great job.
Love it, all the body shots. Yeah, we do.
I asked Zaina, you know, who he looked
Oh, I think Saracho might have got buzzed.
He got buzzed. He's wobbling up there.
He's backing off.
Yeah.
He's keeping his guard really high.
The body language don't lie.
Right hand from Tarik.
I think Zaina realizes he's got his man in a predicament here.
Overhand right from Zaina. Approaching a minute to go in the fifth round. A strong round for the fighter from Gibraltar.
Sportsman.
I think Saracho's recovered. And you hear the corner of Tarik right next to us saying, don't stop, don't stop.
Yeah, don't pose and admire your work. Keep working.
Well, of course we've got the scorecard in the main event only, man. Because the other fights were messing around, not paying attention. Oh, good right hand for Tarik. Another solid right.
Oh, Saracho rocked again by a right uppercut.
10 seconds to go. A strong round for Tarik Zaina. Here are the Thompson Boxing in Ontario.
Joel Diaz gave him a big tongue lashing at the end of that last round, and he responded.
Yes, he did. Wait, there's a fight in Philadelphia tomorrow? Tevin Farmer and Avery Sparrow?
That's a good matchup. I like that.
Remember Avery Sparrow?
Oh, of course, yeah. He can fight.
He was picked up by the authorities.
Oh, yeah. He was
the day of the
way
in Ryan Garcia.
Yeah, in Carson.
Yep.
That was crazy.
He had an outstanding warrant. It was the marshals that came to get him.
Yeah, I heard that was a wild scene.
Yes, it was.
Ah, that's a good Philadelphia matchup, though.
Yeah, he's from Philly. That's a good one.
Yeah, Farmer's a former champion at 130 pounds.
Yeah, good to see him back in the mix. Tevin's a good dude, man. Huh. You know Vadim?
Yeah,
he's a manager for
Vadim
a lot of
Kornilov, yeah.
For a lot of the Uzbeks.
Yes.
He just came over to the corner of Tarik and let him have some words.
What?
But, yeah, but it wasn't in English. I couldn't hear what language it was.
Yeah. Huh.
But yeah, Vadim letting Tarik. So how about this though, Rich? A man who leaves his country, doesn't know anybody, and he picks up a man who's part of the management team for world champions with
Bivol.
Bivol.
Bivol, yeah,
and Joel Diaz. And Adias Jim in Tijuana. Jerry Eisenberg's gonna love this story.
Yeah, no, you know what? Zaina's got some real talent.
Yep.
Normally when you got a guy as tall as he is, to avoid punches, he'll lean back, right? And Tarik just does such a good job in getting under shots. Now, Saracho wings a lot of shots. He throws a lot of haymakers, so, you know, there's some telegraphing there, but I'm impressed with his offense and his defense, and I like the way he blends the two.
Joel Diaz just yelled, he's tired, go.
Saracho looks tired. He looks like he's wading through water.
Body shot. For a fighter who had trouble making weight, those got to take a toll.
Trouble making weight, and it looks like he's maybe put on, like he over-rehydrated, because his back is really big. He just looks like he put on a lot of weight.
You're right. That's a good point there, Doug.
Saracho is still dangerous, though, as you said, with that left hook.
Yeah, Saracho has heavy hands.
That might be all he's got. Breathing heavy in the sixth round, Saracho. Randall, I only had one modelo, man. Next time you come to a fight, bring me two. A master's degree from University of Lee, is that Rich?
That's right.
That's impressive.
And you're boxing.
Now, you know, we've seen a lot of boxers that have bachelor's degrees, but not too many have masters.
Well, I mean, there's a couple PhDs in the Klitschko's, right?
Yeah. That's it, yeah.
Ooh, Saracho's able to get an uppercut in there.
Sleeper, I'm jealous, man. No, blood from the nose of the Mexican, Saracho. Hey, at this point, the way Tarik's fighting, he's Mexican too, representing Tijuana well. This might be a man, you know they say in wrestling, parts unknown? Yeah. This might be the man who's like for everywhere, right? Everybody claims him.
Man of the world.
Yeah, he's from Morocco, he's from Gibraltar, he's from England, he's from Tijuana.
I'll tell you what, he's winning some fans here.
Joel Diaz is really working that corner. Look at him.
Yeah, Joel does not need a microphone tonight. He's on it. And Joel's young fighter, Angel Beltran, had a first round KO earlier. Es el gallo. Seventh round of action coming your way. And yes, Jessica Rosales, I'm so close many times to saying Jesus Saracho. But I'm not, it's Saracho. Tarik Zaina in the black, looking good. Am I saying it right, Rich? Zaina?
Yeah, I think we all were looking at it thinking that it was going to be Tarik Zaina when we first saw it. But
it's Zaina, not Zaina?
Zaina.
It's Zaina. Oh, Zaina.
But he said Tarik.
Tarik Zaina.
He said it's Tarik, yeah.
Because the way he's fighting, we better get it right.
That's right.
Because he's starting to make a name for himself.
Joel Diaz wanted to see more just straight punches, straight jabs and rights and 1-2 combinations.
Very unusual stance. What do you think of that, Doug? I mean, the way he keeps his left hand down low, it's almost cross-armed.
Yeah, it's at times it's kind of a shoulder roll kind of thing.
Here's a comparison.
He's got his body at an angle, but yeah, there's a little bit of cross-arm defense.
Steve Bass, Ty Burningham. What about Sergio Mora comparison?
Yeah, he's got kind of that rhythm. Sergio was like that, although, you know, Sergio would eschew the jab. He would lead with his right hand, and Sergio was a little more herky-jerky. But you know what? Sergio was also one of these tall guys. Didn't have a ton of power, but a lot of heart. Also a cerebral dude. Yep. And Zaina, I think, is a cerebral guy as well.
Does an excellent job on the DAZN broadcast. He'll be on the Berlanga card tomorrow.
Yeah, Snake does a great job.
He has a good battle for Vernon Forrest.
I picked him to beat Forrest. I was one of the few that gave him a shot in that fight. I think he was a 7-1 underdog going into that junior middleweight championship.
Tarik Zaina. Am I saying it right?
Zaina.
Zaina. But I'm saying Tarik, correct.
Tarik you got.
Oh, yeah. Tarik. Wait, all right, hold
on. Tarik, like Derek.
Tarik Zaina. And I only had one beer. My man from Gibraltar looking good.
And all the people watching in Morocco tonight are saying, it's Tarik.
Probably, you know what?
Oh, here's a good line.
Tarik does a good job punching off that pivot, you know? He'll utilize a little bit of lateral movement and then stop and boom, see?
Oh,
out of the way.
That was a surprise.
Saracho still dangerous? Do you think, Rich?
Yeah.
Or is he sleepwalking?
Oh, there's Keenan. Let us know there's 10 seconds. Trying to unload a Saracho. And Tarik looks at him. Little Mark Anthony for you. All right, there you go. As Miner says, it's Tarik in Espanol. Let's look at the replays. Brought to you by Hustler Casino.
Saracho landed on that left to the chest, trying to nail the head, but Zaina does a real good job of blocking shots. But it's clear that when they get down in the trenches, if Zaina sticks around a little bit too long, he can get out-muscled. He can get roughed up a little bit. I don't know if that final flurry was enough to give the round to Saracho. I still scored it for Zaina, but it wouldn't surprise me if at least one of the official judges scored that last round for Saracho.
It was a very good rally by Hayes.
It was. So he's still, he's still got some will.
Right after you asked if he was still dangerous.
He's getting desperate, isn't he, here as we head to the eighth round.
That was a nice shot landed by Saracho.
That's another instruction from the corner, Zaina. Don't think.
Just act.
Act and react.
There you go.
Might surprise you that his favorite fighter, I asked him this yesterday, I expected, them to say Nassim Ahmed for obvious reasons or somebody like that, but some Marvin Hagler.
Marvin Hagler.
What?
Can't go wrong with the marvelous one, huh?
Wow. All right, so this dude is just interesting. I need to go have like a expensive bottle of Camus with him. He's going to break it down. I'm feeling he might be a sommelier or something, right? What do you get a degree in, do you know?
What's that?
What do you get a degree in?
Business and psychology.
Of course he did. Two opposite ends of the spectrum. Business and psychology. All right, well, you need the psychology to deal with boxers. You definitely need the business to make sure your contract is right. Yeah, the Prince, Nassim Ahmed. And there's Saracho snapping back the head.
Yep.
Saracho
has had his moments in this round.
Pues el primo de Guanajuato necesita algo. Saracho's little energy, a little pep now.
He's sort of fought his way into that grinding mode that we talked about at the start of this contest. Maybe Zaina is feeling some fatigue. It's not often that he fights past six rounds. So.
Everybody in the chat, you guys have really interesting scorecards. Let's see if Doug Fisher agrees with you guys. Dougie has Zaina up 69-64.
Yeah, although I've got Saracho winning this round, so Saracho's still in this if he can win the next two rounds.
What up, Kyle? Thanks for joining us. Our main event, Thompson Boxing. The noise and the crowd is here for Saracho. That's Aaliyah, showing us it's the ninth round. Webb says we need Saracho to win the rest of the round, in my eyes. It is a good fight, Emilia Cotalvis. Jesus M has it, 4-4. All right. As does Bill Jackson.
There were some close early rounds. I think the opening round could have gone to Saracho. I thought Zaina just boxed a really good round, however.
Zaina comes out, hands up. As we're here in the ninth, our main event. Thompson Boxing, DoubleTree Hotel in Ontario. The legacy of Mr. Ken Thompson keeps going in its 23rd year.
Now we've had some real interesting fights tonight.
Yeah.
Slugfest, knockouts. This an interesting matchup in terms of style. Chess match, good action.
Yeah.
Chess match is not a derogatory term when you utilize that.
No, absolutely. You know how hard it is to play chess? The rook and the knight doing all kinds of work. That's all I got. Zaina really comfortable in there, isn't he?
I like the head and upper body movement. I like that he's always kind of changing his angles. I like that he has his body at an angle. That's traditional boxing right there.
Saracho knocking out the mouthpiece of Zaina. Yeah. Zaina asking for the mouthpiece. He better put his hands up and protect himself.
Yeah, because he stood motionless there for a moment.
And he gets hit with the left hook.
Yeah, Zaina is still slippery, but Saracho's finding the mark.
The time has been stopped.
Question is, did Saracho do some damage there?
I don't know. Saracho's talking to Zaina, though.
And Zaina speaks Spanish, do you understand?
He knows what he's saying.
Right hand from Zaina. Oh, Saracho gets tagged.
Yeah, Zaina needed to do that. He needed to regain some respect from Saracho.
Uppercut from Zaina. Snaps back the head of Saracho, who holds on.
He's got that right hand, that right cross, which sometimes comes very wide.
It's the cross that's landing, Rich. Saracho's winging. Saracho's looking for a home run. Uppercut from Zaina. Nice. Zaina leading right.
Nice work there.
Yeah, these are eye-catching punches landed by Zaina. The opening minute of the round, it was all Saracho, however.
Yeah.
So this might be one of those swing rounds.
Zaina moving around the ring against the ropes. That's not where he wants to be. He wants to be in the middle. Good work for Zaina getting off the ropes. Saracho bringing the pressure this round.
But when Zaina proves elusive, he can prove to be a very effective puncher at the same time because he punches you from unusual angles.
Yeah, as the old timers would say, he could punch on the fly. It's a tough to score round. Maybe I just like Zaina, but I'm giving that to Zaina.
Mark Anthony, 10th and final round. No pain, no gain on the back of the shirt of Saracho. 9 good rounds. All right, Zaina. They're just yelling in that corner. That's that motivation.
Joel Diaz is never going to let a fighter get complacent in the corner.
Good fight. Good fight. Our main event, 10th and final round. Of course, thanks to everybody that participated in the chat tonight. We appreciate you.
How are they scoring it out there?
All right, there we go. How do we have it? In the 10th and final round. Let's go. I'll read out your scorecards.
Oh, solid shot for Saracho.
Save America. Let me tell you, we all love Zaina. Simple as that. Randall says it's a pick'em. All right.
You know what? I don't agree with that scorecard, but I'm not mad at it because there have been some close rounds here. I scored the last round for Zaina. I think you could argue that Saracho won that. I think the opening round could have gone to Saracho. So.
Jovino, 6-3, Tarik. But he's winning close rounds.
Yes.
The Ozarker, it's been a brawl. Sleeper, I have it even. Somebody needs to do something to separate themselves. Oh, uppercut from Saracho. He's trying to land the big shot. Boxing Vital has it a draw. Jesus has it 4-4. There was no tie in the ninth round, man. Somebody did something.
Oh, that was a nice right hand, but Saracho took it well.
Yeah. There we go. It's close on our unofficial scorecards in the chat. Here's Doug's scorecard, wider than the chat, 88-83.
Saracho's having a pretty good round 10 now.
Damn good round, and there was a couple rounds that could have been either way.
Yeah, I acknowledge that for sure.
Yeah, unofficial scorecard here at ringside. Man. A good main event. Shout out to Alex Caponova putting these two in there. The Southpaw Saracho. Gibraltar. England. Tijuana. Zaina. Oh, good body shot from Saracho. The fight is winding down. 10 seconds to go. Our main event. And that'll do it.
Very enjoyable.
Excellent, fun fight. 10 good rounds. We'll come back with the decision. Thompson Boxing Friday night, locked and loaded indeed. Main event decision coming up.
Live from the Hustler Casino in Gardena, California. Watch the most well-known local and international poker players take the stage and go all in. From low stakes to high stakes, the action will be wild. Tune in to Hustler Casino Live, streaming 5 days a week on YouTube.
Experience Makita's cordless outdoor power equipment. The mower is a part of the world's largest battery system and cuts non-stop for up to 2 miles. The self-propelled model makes mowing effortless. Get unstoppable power without the hassles of gas. Reach speeds of up to 116 miles per hour with the single battery blower. One system, endless possibilities. Now, get 2 extra free batteries.
We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing action to the judges' scorecards, we go. Judges Jerry Cantu and Ron Scott Stevens both see the bout 95 to 95, while Judge Dr. Lou Moret sees about 96-94, declaring this bout a majority draw.
Majority draw? Okay. It was close. It was close, so that
the belt's just vacant.
The belt stays vacant.
Yeah, but, you know, Jesus Saracho and Tarik Zaina put on a heck of a fight in our main event. Obviously, the crowd wants to hear a winner. They want to go, but I'm okay with the draw for these two guys. They went back and forth.
Yeah, it was a really good matchup of styles, and if you favor the forward-marching fighter, the guy who's throwing a lot of heat, then you probably favored Saracho. If you favored the stick-and-move game, the boxer, obviously you favored Zaina. I was for the boxer in this matchup. I had it 97-93 for Zaina.
So, yeah, Zaina win it. Regardless, though, I want to see both of these guys, Rich. They were fun to watch.
Yeah, it was a good matchup. I thought Zaina edged it by a very small margin.
I thought he did just enough. But, hey, a month only as a sparring partner in Joel Diaz's camp. Mike, you can see, I think, a lot of the wrinkles from that sparring some of the best in the world.
Well, we didn't know if he could fight or not. Now we do.
Yeah.
He's real. He's for real. He has potential.
Yeah, there's something about him. He can do that.
Absolutely.
So Jessica Rosales will be talking to both fighters. Again, Thompson Boxing, 23rd year of business. The next show will be July 21st. If you missed any of the fights tonight, make sure you go and check them out. On the YouTube page, they live there. You can go and see that. We had victories earlier. We had 1, 2, 3 knockouts. So you can go and see knockouts by Angel Beltran, Taden Beltran, Nelson Oliva. So you'll see those guys. You can go check out the YouTube page. Make sure you follow the Thompson Boxing Twitter and Instagram for behind-the-scenes pictures. Right now, I want to thank Jeanette Gonzalez, Alex Capanova. We're not saying bye. I just want to make sure to give everybody their shout-out. Carlitos, our photographer, does a great job. Paul LaFornia, Little Joe and La Familia. Everybody that helps out on the crew. There's not that many of us. We just make it look like it's a big-time production. And, of course, it's free for you, the fans, and why we do it every single month. Also, we got UFC fighter Brian Ortega here in attendance. Brian, go ahead, Brian. So you'll see Brian going into the ring right now. We're going to take a picture. T-Town, strong UFC fighter. He spars a lot of boxing guys, too. Jessica Rosales is standing by. All right, Keenan, good job on the timekeeping tonight. Nothing like having 5-minute rounds from you. All right, Jessica Rosales standing by with one of the fighters.
All right, we've got Tarik Zaina joining us here. Of course, we tried to grab Jesus Saracho, but they took him to the back already. So we'll talk to Tarik about tonight's draw. First and foremost, do you feel like you did enough to win this fight tonight?
I mean, of course I did. Everyone, you know, you saw the fans, they were all saying or thinking that I won. But at the end of the day, you know, I can only blame myself. I feel, you know, you can always do more, you can always do better. I should have thrown more combinations, should have put more pressure on him. You know, I'm the away fighter, so, you know, it is what it is. I'm not going to sit here and complain and tell you I should have won, it's bullshit, whatever. You know, I should have done more, and that's it. It is what it is, so.
And so, of course, your last two fights were scheduled for 8 rounds. They went the distance, you went those 8 rounds, but this is the first time that you've gone 10. How did you feel in those last 2 rounds?
Yeah, it was good. It didn't help when I dropped my mouth guard. You know, I tried looking for it instead of carrying on fighting. He probably snicked that round when that happened. It's all right. I could have done another 2, but it is what it is. So,
you talk about that moment with the mouth guard. Was that your first thought when they announced draw that you kind of thought back to, like, maybe that kind of ruined it for him?
Yeah, exactly that. Yeah, it was like the Errol Spence and Ugas. He dropped his mouth guard and he went to look for it instead of fighting. And I feel like I let that round slip when I went to look for the mouth guard. So, yeah, that could have been the difference.
Will you be watching this fight back to make those adjustments moving forward?
Of course. it's exactly what I'm going to do. I can't wait to rewatch it and make adjustments and do better next time.
I think also with you, a lot of the people that have been watching online, one of the things that our announcers were talking about is your story and your journey to get to where you have been, just to continue in the sport of boxing. We know how you got here, but we want to know what's next for you. What is the plan moving forward?
Well, I'd like to fight him again, you know, and correct the wrong and get a bigger fight, you know. That's it. I'm just a bit disappointed because, you know, it was a draw. But other than that, you know, I'd like to fight him again and keep getting these big fights.
You're pretty confident in that next fight. If you get that fight against him, you'd win it.
100%. It's just minor adjustments, more combinations, you know, being more focused, and that's it. So,
Tarik, thank you so much for the time tonight.
Thank you very much to Thompson Boxing for the opportunity, and I want to thank all the fans. And, you know, I'm sorry it went this way, but, you know, next time I'll be better.
Sounds good. Thank you so much for the time. All right, guys, we will send it ringside to Betho, to Doug and Rich.
No, bro. I know what I'm talking to. Brian Ortega, T-Town UFC fighter, was here watching here tonight. He said, I used to come here years ago to watch the Thompson shows when Efren Esquivias, a good friend of his, used to fight here at the Doubletree. So you never know who might pop in. Beth Duran, Greg Fisher, and Rich Murata here ringside wrapping up tonight's show. And Rich, the main event, we didn't know who this man from Gibraltar was.
Yeah.
But now we do know, and I know we want to see more of him. He was fun to watch, even though in the draw.
He was the Rock of Gibraltar tonight. And he, you know, he's very, as Doug put it, very elusive in there. He's got a lot of abilities. And I think now, you know, this is only his 13th fight, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, he will develop. He's an interesting character, too. And Saracho lived up to his reputation as a grinder, hung in there, stayed in there, even when things seemed to be going the other way. I thought Zaina edged it, but it was a close fight.
And Doug, we mentioned this in the beginning of the broadcast. When you're undefeated and you're moving up along the side and such on Thompson shows, it's if, yeah, you're going to win, but it's how you win. And tonight we had three knockouts from young fighters, which is good. They got tested, but absolutely, they had to knock them out.
Yeah, and they provided entertainment for us. They advanced their careers. They get that much-needed experience. And some guys, like Nelson, you know, I think they learn from their previous bout. You know, like, let me make this easy on myself. My bread and butter is power and going to the body. Let me just do that. And he did that. And I'm glad, because otherwise it'd be like after midnight. We'd be sitting here. So
exactly.
I appreciate the knockouts on this card.
Yeah, and those two Beltran kids.
Very look good.
They got something going for them, each one of them.
Angel Beltran.
He looks really good.
Really good.
That was the first round.
First round knockout.
First round, yeah.
So make, if you miss any of the fights tonight, go back to the YouTube page, watch them. You can replay. Make sure you hit the like button on that. For everybody behind the scenes, thank you so much for Alex Campanola, Jeanette Gonzalez, Kai Monroe, doing the pictures, and everybody involved with Thompson Boxing. Of course, an homage to the late, great Ken Thompson, who passed away in his 23rd year of boxing. He would have loved tonight's show. Would have just had that thumbs up and the big smile waiting for everybody. For my partners, Rich Murata, Doug Fisher, and of course, the one and only Jessica Rosales, I'm Beto Duran. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again July 21st on Thompson Boxing.